Don't dig up more snakes than you can kill.
So I am recording. This is session 4 of East Texas University.
I think so.
We've been neglecting the fact that these guys have leveled up, so we're going to level up really quick. We also have a new...
Do we have exams coming up soon?
It's only like mid-October.
Which one?
It's about time for midterms.
Get there. Go ahead, Jeff.
Spirit is if you get like shaken, like something scares you, spirit.
Yeah.
Like that bigger?
That's my cheat sheet.
I think it's bigger to soak spirit to me.
Bigger shake, to soak
spirit
moon.
For shaken. Confirmed. Spirit is shaken.
Alright, I think I've bought my spirit up after what I've seen this.
And soak is bigger.
So we are leveling up now. We also have a new player joining us.
Are you going to introduce him in the course of the game?
I'm going to introduce Chris Jones as a player, and his character will be joining us shortly.
Oh, all right.
I actually have it in for him tonight already.
So two or three sessions he's going to join us?
Yep.
Wait, were you playing Dungeons and Dragons?
Did we do that one session?
Oh, no, just the sessions dragged on much longer than originally anticipated.
That's right.
I can remember thinking, we're going to be done with 4E in like 3 months. 8 months later.
8 months later, we made it to paragraph here.
Yes. So, all right, so who's level one? Jeff, Johnny Moon?
He's seen some shit that would turn you white, I guess. And, so he bumped up his spirit. He's ready for this.
He's ready for this?
His spirit is the trait that keeps you from being stunned when you experience something, is that right? Although, with the new change, what's that new errata change to Savage Worlds about spirit and shaking?
You can, if you recover from shaking, you can act regularly.
Oh, you don't get frozen for the entire time. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So, what did Edison do, Bob?
Edison Redman, he's a 98-pound weakling, but now he's been in college for a month and a half, eating the dorm food and all those pizzas that we've won. So he's gained the freshman 15.
I always pictured him as a
big boy.
And he's now 104 pounds. So his vigor went from a D4 to a D6.
Doesn't that make his vigor go down? I guess it depends.
He's got a little more to him now. He's not just sticks on a scarecrow with bones jutting out everywhere. He's still scarecrow-ish.
Just not quite as much.
He's not emaciated, sort of. I guess,
Is he still pale?
Incredibly pale.
Alabaster
porcelain skin that has never seen the harsh light of day.
Okay, so he's still programming.
Yeah, and he still looks incredibly thin. Like, it's just that he's got a little more padding.
Alright, we are missing Joel tonight. So Trout will be tagging along in the background should Joel join us, potentially.
I thought he was going home to visit his estate.
He said he might be checking in with us, so we will leave him as a background character for the time being. What did
Joe Diffie do?
Joe decided to raise his spirit as well. After all of the strange and weird things we've been experiencing. He's a little tougher, so his spirit's gone up.
What's his spirit at now?
D8.
Wow. And Johnny Moon, what's yours at?
6.
Wow, okay. Oh, you started at D4 spirit.
8.
Oh. Wait, so now it's at D8.
Yeah.
Okay.
You said you went from a D4 to a D8 to a D6?
I don't know the game that well, but I know.
I know that 8 is more than 6.
Jeff is Johnny Moon. What was your nickname, Jeff?
Moody's.
Cochise.
Engine.
I was going to say Engine Boy.
Cochise. Adam is...
Juan Lo.
I lost my cheat sheet.
Sexy.
Juan Lo Montgomery.
Especially in that shirt.
And what did you do anything?
Yeah. You know, I think Juan Lo's been so busy, he hasn't really particularly paid attention to what all he's improved at. Because I want to look it over a little more than I have to. Alright, call me Mike.
Alright, and Chris, well, we'll introduce you in a few minutes, Chris.
You got it. Is Adam's character Juan Lo, is his dad Hung Lo?
Oh, I missed the tacky humor. Ba-dum-bum. Alrighty. So it's mid-October and you get an email from Glenn Mack asking you guys to come visit him. He has something he wants you guys to look into for him.
Hey, Chris, Glenn Mack is our guidance counselor / professor / investigator of paranormal
things.
So
I'm assuming you guys go meet with him.
No, actually.
I have some studying to do.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm going to visit him.
Guys, I would highly suggest that it's important. Damn it, I keep losing the Texas accent when I go for the geek. And when I go for the Texas accent, then I lose the geek. I got to figure that out. I think we should go see him. He's important. Besides, you might be able to make some money if he sends us someplace.
I'm in.
Coach East does not have a lot of money.
What day of the week is this?
The Tuesday.
Oh, but it's
is it pizza night?
I was gonna say it's a holy day of obligation though, isn't it all a third day? I gotta go to church, so guys, let me know how it went. Alright, fine, I'll go.
Alright. So Glenn Mack is waiting for you. You note that his graduate assistant Jackson Green is not there. You know, obviously usually you see them as a pair.
Alright.
So Glenn Mack welcomes you guys in. He says, listen, guys, a couple months ago, through the use of some of Google Maps and satellite images, some people located some Mayan ruins further north than we ever expected to find them. And the Mexican government asked us, because we have a great archaeology staff, to come out and take a look. And we have some stuff going on, and they're asking for a few more students to come down for a few days. And I volunteered you guys, because I need you to look at some stuff for me.
So these are... We're going to investigate Mayan ruins in Madrid Bay, Mexico. Oh,
no. Yes.
Whoa.
I just want to... This is out of character.
Yes, Mr. Moon.
From what I understand is the Mayans never made it north of the Yucatan.
That is exactly why we're so interested in this site, because this is the furthest the Mayan civilization has ever been detected this far north.
So they've been hanging out with the Aztecs?
That's what I want you to do, guys, to go and see. So what I'm going to...
That's Teotihuacan.
Exactly.
We just exhausted all of your Mesoamerican knowledge.
I have to say, John, that's very impressive.
Such and Tenochtitlan.
Tenochtitlan! That's civilization right there.
So
what I need you guys to do is bring back anything you can. Obviously, don't burn any bridges. Our own doctor, Chad Doherty, is going to be in charge. He's the archaeology professor here. And on site, you'll meet Dr. Where's his name go? Dr. Vanderkamp. He's also an assistant professor here. He's supervising the excavation work. So I need you to take rubbings of anything you can.
Yes.
And he gives you a big pile of paper. You're welcome, Mikey.
Being in college, I think we're all really good at taking rubbings.
Not Johnny Moon. He's good at getting rubbed.
I try to hide the evidence.
It's going to be about... You're going to be gone almost...
Socks.
Stay away from those socks.
You're It's you're going to be gone close to a week. It's a day and a half, 2 days to get down there by the bus. That leaves on Thursday.
Roommate sucks.
Oh, Chris, since you've missed this, everybody's roommate is a member of the American Pie Gang. So Jeff's roommate is Jim. His room always smells like apple pie. Adam, once again, Wando's roommate is...
I think it was Finch.
Finch.
Edison, Edison's Stifler? Roommate, Edison got...
Stifler.
No, Mikey got Stifler. And Edison got...
Oz.
Oz. And Joel, his character is well off, so he has his own room. Mm-hmm. So
and he couldn't find his passport.
Don't mind me.
You looking, Bob, looking it up? All right, so the bus leaves about 8 o'clock on Thursday morning. I'm going to give you guys each $75. I'm going to give you guys each $75 as a stipend. There's a supply store down there where the bus stops, so get what you need. The school's picking up all your food.
Hi, cerveza.
So, you know, if you got a sleeping bag, bring it. If you don't, buy one. If you need something else, pick it up at the supplies or bring it with you.
Professor Mack?
Yes, sir.
Is it possible for us to borrow some of your more advanced equipment, such as the ones that you used to detect hot spots when we were back at the auditorium 2 months ago?
Normally, I would happily let you borrow that, except the reason Jackson's not here is he's out doing an investigation on something else. He's taking the equipment with him.
Oh, all right. All right, then. Thank you, sir.
I want you guys to know I spend an inordinate amount of time rationalizing how certain things will play out tonight so that you don't have easy loopholes to beat me with.
Bob will find new loopholes.
That's fine, but I worked hard not to find the easy ones. I've worked hard to plug the easy holes.
Is that a dare?
Now, sir, it doesn't matter. We got Bob.
Yes, Edison.
I am working on a double major, and my classwork is very important to me. Will you be able to write a note to my
professor? I have notified all of your professors, and they've agreed to provide some leniency on timings for things.
My football coach?
Football coach says 200 burpees a day, and you're good.
Okay.
Are you missing any games, Johnny?
Are you on the start of the squad yet, or are you still on practice squad?
Still on practice squad.
How about, you know who I haven't seen around in a while? That pretty girl that you used to hang out with. Are you guys still together? Oh, all right. She must be like a night owl, because I see her, like, she seems like she comes to your place at night, but then she leaves by the day.
We do some studying, you know.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah, she's like a vampire, isn't she?
Something like that.
Wow.
Yeah. She sucks.
Does she suck the blood of innocent men?
Not innocent.
All right, so you guys want to make it? You leave in a day and a half. You can buy stuff now. He gives you your $75. You can buy stuff now. You can pack what you have. You can just bring a sheet and call it a night if you want to save a few bucks on sleeping bags. You can buy sleeping bags. You can bring in your toothbrush, whatever you got to do. He did say food was taken care of. So your $75 will stretch as far as you want it to stretch. And there's a general store down there which will sell most of the things you need.
Hand it up.
What was that?
Hand it up. It's not general, it's hand it up.
Okay.
So we're just to make sure I'm clear, the scope of our investigation is to go down there with our paper and our charcoal and just create rubbins and then collect the rubbins and then come back.
He said bring back whatever you can find.
And anything that you find interesting, that you think he would be interested in, or the archaeology department will let you bring back or borrow.
Do we
think? And the Mexican government needs to let us know who's coming back to. Oh, we just don't let them know.
This is very exciting. I happen to have a passport from one time when I went to a junior mathlete competition.
I thought it was band camp.
In Canada?
Back in Canada? Yeah, it was very foreign. All the people were so different, you know, it was like they were talking a different language. You know,
kept talking about A.
Yeah.
And they wanted to go to this place called Timmy Hortons.
Yeah. But it was just like a donut place. But this guy Timmy, he's very popular.
It was Dunkin' Donuts, but it said Tim Hortons. Well, I don't know if Dunkin' Donuts is in Texas.
Like a Waffle
House. Oh, no. Tim Hortons. Listen, I do not like the Canadians, but Tim Hortons is not Dunkin' Donuts.
Way better?
Oh my God, way better. Dunkin' Donuts sucks.
Well, we could answer. We all do that.
Thank you for checking yourself there, Sam.
Do we think that we're gonna get into any kind of trouble while we're down there?
No. Why would we get into any trouble? That's just crazy. We'll be fine. We're no trouble.
That's a good point. You're right.
Just to help us, put that one back in there.
I got a crazy question. So we buy sleeping bags. Are we just sleeping outside in these sleeping bags? Do we need tents? Do we need anything?
Oh my
else?
God. It's like trying to start a D&D adventure.
It's fun.
I mean, like, hold on a second. I got a cart with about 17 javelins in it.
Mikey, give yourself an extra Benny.
It was 10 javelins. Thank you very much.
And everybody make sure you grab a 10-foot pole. And that's bring right. your own rope. Always bring your own rope.
Well, Joe Diffy travels everywhere with his 10-foot pole.
Oh!
But I'm pumped. It was kind of implied there'd be tents down there, or at least something to cover you, but not a bag, not a sleeping bag, but a tent or a lean-to or something like that. Yeah, something to keep the weather off.
I'll find a sleeping bag. I'll find one of them nice little archaeology students to bunk with.
Another question. During last week's
preferably the female variety.
During the last adventure, I guess it was 2 weeks ago now. 3 weeks ago? Oh my gosh. Juan Lo found a book on rituals that he was given at the bookstore by the lady at the bookstore.
That's right.
Have we had a chance to look through that book, and did we find anything of interest?
Since no one emailed or asked about it, no.
Well, don't punish us because we didn't ask before the game. Now that we're playing the game.
Didn't I just make this question, this loophole?
Can you Juan Lo?
Yeah, last time Jeff asked me questions, he went to see his grandmother about stuff, and we had a lovely chat with her.
Sure.
You learned lots. You got a glimpse of whatever the needler was, or what Johnny Moon saw, and he did that out of game time.
Okay.
So if you want something to happen out of game time, you have to have it happen out of game time.
I'm just wondering if we get a special cool ritual.
I think we should spend half an hour right now looking over that book.
Yeah.
All right.
Are you on the spot? Should we skip over this?
Whatever you want.
I turn to page one. What does it say?
Introduction.
I didn't think.
What should we do next?
I really didn't think this was unreasonable. I'm sorry.
I'm not trying to be obnoxious about it either. No, you guys open. I've looked at the ritual book. There's stuff in there. You know, there's a list of. I don't want to use the word components, but you know,
ingredients
focuses. Yeah, foci that you need to create a ritual. There's certain parts of a ceremony. There's no description on what they do though. So you've been hesitant to... There's only a couple in there. No description on what to do. One requires a full moon. You haven't had a full moon yet since it happened.
We got a Johnny moon just
happened.
Hey. Keep your pants on, Johnny.
One requires a virgin. You can't find one of those anywhere.
It is 3 weeks into the semester.
I will give anybody the full moon. Who I think is best.
Yeah, I wonder where we could find a virgin. Because I'm not a virgin. And
it was this girl in Canada once, right?
And that would still be legal. Hey, I think I saw a picture of a virgin. Joshy?
Oh, God, no. We don't need to just...
Is there a picture?
There is a picture of... Let's not forget now.
Hey, I'm still chewing.
I didn't eat pizza, but I ate a lot. You don't want that coming back.
So Josh is calling forth a picture, and I'll use this moment to say that I saw Things We Do in the Shadows this weekend, which is by the guy from Flight of the Conchords. It's a documentary that follows vampires, and they discover the internet. And they're talking to a guy who's handy with the internet, and of course they're hundreds of years old. They've never seen.
So Chris.
And they're like, can we see pictures of virgins on these?
Did your screen just center on Roxanne Stevenson?
Oh
You don't have roll 20 working yet, do you?
No, I don't have working.
Oh, I'm just going to send you a picture then. Roxanne Stevenson is a woman, young lady.
Girl.
That has found Juan Lo extremely attractive and intriguing.
The Asian sensation.
She, on the other hand, is not the most attractive of people. Physically and...
emotionally, spiritually, mentally.
Yeah, psychologically.
Man, you guys are just hard on this poor woman.
No, we're not. We're specifically not hard on
her. There were no hard-ons around.
I gotta agree with Jeff on this one.
Well, I guess I'll live with her, so we should rock.
You're like a piece of
wood. Let's put it this way, Chris. When I Google ugly college girl, she's the first one to come up on the list. So, I'm gonna send you a quick picture of that.
It's bad.
Just so you can have it for posterity. You have eaten tonight, right?
Yes.
All right, so there she is. So there's Roxanne, sent to Chris now. I'm waiting for the Chris to scream and scare.
And horror.
In horror.
He was a twin whose brother was an Indian outlaw, but so, he was not.
All right, so back to the well, Chris, wait, so you guys...
So I'm thinking then maybe we just get the components for one of these things, even if we don't know what it does.
Oh, my God.
You know?
Oh, my God.
That's
too.
A little better.
Did you get it yet, Chris?
Rather do it.
Not yet.
Really?
Hold on.
Check your Gmail.
Oh, all right.
Mikey, I just sent the picture of Roxanne to Chris. I'm waiting for his visual response.
Oh, boy.
It's like the girls on cut videos.
Chris, there isn't enough
power here it is.
To make this girl look pretty.
Okay, let's see here. Oh. What? That's not real. Is that, what is that? Like the Hulk on steroids?
Chris, is that
Lou Ferrigno's illegitimate child? Oh my gosh. Well, you know what? Hey,
he's shaking.
Is she missing a finger? What the?
Chris, how would you describe
her sausages?
Actually, Chris, she's only got one finger up.
Chris, how would you describe Roxanne to people listening to audio?
But okay, so some women, right, at 10 o'clock or at 2, and at 2 o'clock or at 10, she's a zero.
My good,
looks like Lou Ferrigno's illegitimate child, or oh my God.
Who never...
you are so being mean to Lou Ferrigno.
Wait a sec. Anybody watch Shrek?
It's Shrek.
There she is. There's his wife.
I know. I think Fiona looks a little better than that.
I know. I think Fiona looks much nicer than that.
Somebody put hair on a basketball.
To be sure, there is a timestamp on that. And, you know, we were all very crazy back in 2008. So.
Shrek's ugly older brother. I think that's
pretty good.
I'm the pretty one. Have you met my brother?
All right, so
she's shaved. She'd be fine.
It gets to be Thursday. You guys board the bus.
So wait, just to clarify, we are going to take one ritual that is not on a full moon that we can do. We're going to pick up the components for it before we leave, and perhaps we'll have to do a ritual at some point to save ourselves. And who knows? Maybe it'll help us. Maybe it'll hurt us.
But okay.
It'll be a TPK.
Yeah.
Either way, it'll be an adventure.
Right? You do realize there's tables in here for what happens when the ritual is not successful.
Sure. Nice. I always love it when there's a plan when we get.
That sounds fun.
Because then we don't have to succeed.
Yes. So you guys board the bus. There's maybe three or four of the kids on there. You know, Chris didn't send me a picture yet. I didn't ask for one, so that's my own fault. Chris, do you wish to describe yourself physically, or you just want to say you're there and we'll let you pick a picture later on?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm in the middle of the bus towards the window.
All right. Jeff recognizes Missy Jordan, his sometime girlfriend. How she found out or whatever, or she's an archaeology major, we don't know, but she is on the bus as well.
Hey, John the Moon, she's not a vampire after all. Look, there she is in broad daylight.
You have like a day and a half on the bus to talk to her.
Okay, we're going well.
Huh. Chris, I never knew that's what a Ford Prefect looked like.
Oh.
This so, is what I expected to see.
I don't think Chris meant that Ford Prefect. I think he meant Andrew Dice Clay, Ford Fairlane.
Oh.
Wait, Chris, who did you mean? Well, I guess when he described
we'll find out.
Yes, you'll have to describe. So the bus boards, there's a couple of the people you don't know on there. There's Missy Jordan, who you recognize, and Chris's character.
Yeah, where's our picture of Missy Jordan?
It is, by the way, Ford Prefect. It's mistyped.
Ford Prefect. So just like the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy character.
100%.
Okay, Adam, I know you're looking for, actually, Adam is looking for...
Jordan Peter.
That's not
her. Jordan Gray.
Oh, Jordan Gray. Sorry.
That is not her, for the record.
I don't care what her name is.
That's what Adam's looking for. Chris, too bad Chris can't see it. So, all right. I'll just leave it there for now so you can be distracted.
Who's the boss?
Yeah, who's the boss?
No, that was Alyssa Milano.
Same person, right?
No, it's not. That's Jennifer Love Hewitt.
Oh, no.
Oh, my bad.
So. All right, so the bus, the...
15, 20 years old.
The... heavyset gentleman comes puffing on at the last minute, introduces himself as...
Trout's already here.
Trout's there. This is a man, not a boy. Introduces himself as Dr. Chad Doherty. You can call him Dr. Chad.
Hey, the archaeology professor.
Hey, Dr. Chad.
That is correct. So, guys, I want to thank you all for volunteering to come down. It's going to be kind of a long bus ride. It's about almost a day to get down there with some stops. And then it's a several-hour ride to the actual excavation site up in the mountains. We're going to see what we can find.
This is great. How about we all play a rousing game of Star Trek Trivial Pursuit next generation, of course, only between seasons 4 and season 7. I'll start. How many lights were there? Anybody?
What the hell are you talking about?
Oh. Missy Jordan raises her hand. 4!
What did she say specifically?
There are 4 lights! 4 lights!
Oh, I like you, Missy. Vampire.
All right, so the bus pulls on out. It's up to you guys. You want to talk to yourselves or talk to the people? Obviously, you know Missy. There's one of the male and one of the female.
We go in the back seat.
Oh, because you're cool?
Nope.
Edison is sitting in the front seat.
You and Missy.
With a blanket.
He's absolutely all the way in the front of the bus in the front seat.
Go and Cochise are in the back smoking a doob.
Wanlow is towards the front keeping Edison company and staying on top of
it. Ford top and has his camera plugged in.
So Ford.
Plugged into what?
The laptop I have.
Oh, okay. The laptop?
So Wanlow, you know, I don't think I've gotten any classes
with
you. What are you studying anyway?
Where's Missy Jordan?
I study architecture.
Oh, wow.
I want to be an architect. I like the buildings here in Texas. Well, up there in Texas.
That's great. How are you finding classes so far in life in Texas?
It's a big challenge. I didn't realize that there was so much history in architecture. A lot to learn. A lot to learn about all the old buildings.
Hey, Wanlow, one thing I need to tell you, we're driving south here, so... Anytime someone asks you a question, all you got to say is, remember the Alamo.
Thank you, Joe Diffie.
It'll get you by down in the southern part of the state. That's all I'm saying.
You're going into Mexico, though.
Exactly.
Jesus.
Remember the Alamo. That's all I'm saying.
So, if you... Hold on a second.
Do y'all know who else is on the bus with us? Are they all going to the archaeological dig like we are?
Hey, you there.
There's Missy. Hey, there's Missy Jordan for you.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
I can't cover the money for that scene. Yeah, who I'd probably...
Anybody.
Not quite.
Anybody.
Close.
Roxanne. Roxanne's close. Not on the bus. Wanlow was secretly disappointed that Roxanne didn't get on the bus somehow.
No, he's not. There's nowhere to hide.
There's nowhere to hide. Oh, I should have put her on.
I gotta burn my eyes, but anyway.
All right, so there's three other people you don't recognize on the bus in addition to the professor, Dr. Chad.
Hey, how you guys doing?
He's talking in your general direction, Chris.
Oh, I said. Who? Are you talking to me?
Yeah.
I'm doing quite well. What about you?
Good. My name is Johnny Moon.
Johnny Moon, unusual name. Where are you from, Johnny Moon?
I'm from Northern Texas.
Northern Texas. That would put you about where?
Briscoe.
The north part of Texas?
About Briscoe.
Chris, if you Google it, it's the most desolate place on the planet.
The part?
It's right around a Comanche reservation.
Oh, you do have that look about you. Interesting. Does your family live there long? One of the first Indian settles?
They've been there for a long time, yeah.
Huh.
My mom was very family. Actually, my dad is family. My name is Moon.
Oh, very interesting. What brings you on this trip?
You know, I'm interested in...
$75.
$75.
Yeah, well, I noticed you don't have much equipment with you. Is this your first time?
You know what? I'm used to sleeping out under the stars.
All right. Well, that makes quite sense to me. Who's the other people you're talking to here?
What, you guys are missing the obvious line. What's your major?
Right, in college.
We got Juan Low over here.
Hi, Dad. How you doing?
Fantastic. Yourself, Juan Low?
I'm doing very good, thank you.
In the back of the bus over there is Joe Durfee?
Joe Diffie. Juan Low's major is architecture.
Architecture.
What's up, Prof?
I didn't catch up. My internet's crudding in and out, so I can't hear.
What was your name again?
My name's Ford.
Ford, like the car?
Well, like the car. My parents were weird.
Ford, like the Harrison?
You got a last name Ford? Oh, you got a first name Ford?
What's your name?
It's Prefect.
Agricultural, sir.
Your name is Prefect?
The long story behind the prefect name. The prefect name actually goes back to the old Welsh.
For prefect,
meetings.
You gotta ask.
Hey, we got.
It actually got changed.
It used to be shit ass.
We got 20 hours, so you might as well tell us.
How come I've never seen you all on campus before?
We're freshmen?
Well, what's your major? What year are you in?
Well, I'm a freshman as well. I just transferred over just about a month ago. Down from Houston. Communications, my major, journalism is my focus.
So then I've got a very important question for Prefect. Is that a solid state 4 terabyte RAM hard drive that I see in front of you right there, or are my eyes deceiving me?
Oh, you are correct. Good eyes.
Yeah, it's a nice piece of equipment.
Well, I do a lot of downloading, and anything I can get on, I try to get on to... Wait, hold on a minute.
See, you're trying to get on.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying. Hold on. I gotta stop the porn I'm watching. Hold on.
There you go. No wonder why you're so quiet.
I hear those start and stop within like 2 seconds. You shut it down and then you hit the button and it's just on, basically.
That is true. It helps me out when I need to download fast in a GIF.
That's nice. I'm Edison Redman, by the way. It's very nice to make your acquaintance.
Edison Redmond, nice to meet you. What are you here for? What's your major?
Oh, I major in computer science and also had another dual major in mechanical engineering.
Oh, in engineering. Well, very smart.
Well, I would have liked to have done chemistry, but the order forbids me from ever practicing chemistry again.
Legally.
Oh, all right. Well, I do notice an accent. Where are you from?
I'm from around town. I'm from East Texas.
Well, you're a local.
No, not a local. Easter. Far Easter.
Like
almost Louisiana.
I'm not one of them.
I'm not one of the Louisianans.
Yeah, no, they're awful. Dirty Louisianans.
And who's that gentleman in the back? Joe, who's the what?
That's Joe Diffie.
Joe Spiffy? Joe Diffie. Is that with two Fs?
With two Fs. Yeah, two Fs is good.
Joe, today. Sure. Well, that's great.
Pleased to meet you, Joe Diffie. What brings you here?
Well, my parents brought me here. I mean, that's pretty much the reason I'm here. Otherwise, I'd be back home partying. Well, I major in psychology and sociology, but my concentration is in women.
I see. Interesting. You'll have to help me with that major soon.
I think I can help you. I helped put Keith out the other day. Juan Lowe's not so bad, but that little nerd boy next to us, he's useless as tits on a bowl.
Well, with him, obviously, we all look like a 10.
No kidding.
No offense, Edison.
In a whorehouse with a fistful of
about?
What are you guys talking about? I don't understand. Something Edison, about Edison, bull breeding?
Edison, do me a favor. My cell phone's not working again. Can you fix this?
Sure. Here, hand it over. I'm sure it just has something to do with the way the battery's inserted. Plus, there's so much bloatware on these things. Here, let me just help you out.
Yeah, you go ahead, Edison. You work on that. I'm going to talk to the gentleman over here.
The headline for the rotary girder.
Like I said, Edison's kind of like a little wind-up doll. You don't got much attention. He just kind of runs around in circles.
Hey,
interesting.
Hey, Joe Diffie, you got an app on here called Tinder, but I don't think it's spelled right. I think it's missing an E.
Yeah, no, that's okay. You can leave that one alone there, Edison.
All right. Okay, I've never seen that one before.
Yeah, that's a special app for the university for psychology majors.
Oh, he's got one called Grindr. It's spelled without that same E.
Yeah, that's weird.
missing from the introduction is Joel's character. I forget his first name.
His
nickname is Trout. He's a takeoff on Flounder from the Animal House.
Uh-huh.
He's a petroleum engineer, and his family is rich.
Filthy rich.
Thank goodness for him.
Ridiculously rich.
Ridiculously rich. Why are we taking a bus down? Anyway.
They pretty much built half the campus of the college that we're on.
They have donated. Since you've missed it, Chris, these guys successfully evacuated the gym before burning it down to the ground.
You may remember that. It was on freshman day.
We did get everybody out first, though. That's all that
you did.
Important.
All
right. They won the town scavenger hunt, where they each get a free pizza a week for the semester.
Yep.
It was a great call.
And what was a great call?
That.
The pizza thing.
Yeah.
That was a good one. That made that one up. And then last week, after citing some scary stuff, they went to visit Cochise's grandmother, who is an ancient medicine woman, Indian medicine woman. And they had their brains straightened out a little bit, and they got to see what Cochise saw, and they're sleeping well.
And we got our spirit.
What's really cool is she gave us all cool Indian names. Well, she gave most of us cool Indian names, and then there was Edison.
What did you call Edison?
Hey, listen, I don't know about you.
Babbling Brook.
I had a very good Indian name. My Indian name is very reflective of myself, a production of much meditation and thinking. Thank you.
Babbling Brook.
The Indian name she gave you was Babbling Brook.
Yeah, exactly. What's wrong with that? I thought that was a really good name. Lots of brooks, you know, water flowing. I thought that was sort of a very good name for me. It was very apropos.
It's the name of a girl who talks too much.
Oh, do you think that she meant that I talk too much?
I also think she meant that you look like a girl.
Oh. Oh, right, man. Well, I didn't think about that. I just thought the ramifications of a babbling brook, but I pay no attention to that. Like my mama always said, sticks and stones can break your bones, but names can never hurt you. Unless they say it really mean, and then they make you cry, and then you're dehydrated, and you die of dehydration, then I guess in truth, they could hurt you.
Hey, Chris?
Yes, please?
In your Google Hangouts on the left-hand side,
or if you mentioned
there's a blue icon, a yellow, a green icon, a camera.
Who you should not.
Do you see those? And then below that is three dots.
No, all I've got is the invite people microphone.
Go over to the left, all the way to the left. Does that pop out?
Yeah, you may have to move the mouse over there.
Hold on.
Or click on the picture.
I'm just trying to get them roll 20 so you can see the pictures.
No, I don't have any dice, and I'm, you know.
Yeah, but you don't see anything over there on the left? If you push your mouse all the way to the left margin, you get nothing? Are you on your tablet or
nothing.
On a PC?
No, I'm on a PC.
Huh.
I just got the window with you all on it.
Can you try Googling how to add Roll 20 to Google Hangouts and see if it gives you step by step?
How do you not have the bar?
Let's
Yeah, so I'm trying to. Like,
it's a pane too. Don't you have to open up the pane?
Well, if you click on the dots at the bottom, Adam, you can add an app, and I assume you can search for Roll 20 there.
I've got nothing but.
What do you got there, Bob?
Maple.
Let's see.
I gotta try one of those.
Sure?
Yeah, I can do one. Thank you.
No, nothing yet. I'll figure it out, don't you worry.
Alright, so, it's not a giant deal.
Mm-hmm. I'm always looking for a picture of pancakes on my desk.
No.
It just kind of tastes like
honey
barbecue.
It don't taste much.
A little bit, yeah. So,
Bless Ride is pretty lame. You guys get the information from the other guys. Tony Hoffman is a cultural studies major. His interest is, of course, ancient Mexican cultures. And Joy Hines, a female, a woman, and she is an actual archaeology major.
All freshmen?
Yes. And then Dr. Chad. The bus ride is long and boring. You cross the border without incident. It looks like Dr. Chad called ahead or something, and you know they had school information, and they were expecting you, so they let you go through.
Did I get my passport stamped? Because I really want a stamp from Mexico on my passport. That would be really great.
Well, they don't stamp it at the border. You have to go to somewhere special, don't you? You have to get a stamp now?
It depends on how lazy the border guards are, but they will stamp it at the border, usually.
This is Mexico. They're pretty fucking lazy.
Okay.
Been to the Mexican restaurants in Monterrey.
So they let getting into Mexico is easy. It's the out part that's the challenge.
Yeah, that's for sure.
So you mosey on down. You end up somewhere near the Sierra Madre Mountains.
Oh, we're that far.
Yeah. Is there a treasure in the Sierra Madre?
No. Well, you don't know.
So we do need the sneaky badges.
Hey, is this where that mountain chicken itchy's from?
Did you need some pizza? That's a title of an episode of a kid's show that Adam's kids and my kids enjoyed.
Oh, yeah. I missed that reference
many, many months ago.
Chichin. Liz started watching it again, but anyway.
Thank you.
Very good.
Good
job. Are we going to be exploring the temples of Chicken and G?
There's only like four seasons.
Not quite there.
I used to watch that.
All right, so the bus stops. unloads you guys. It's a small town. There's a general store. There's a small restaurant.
Does anybody here speak Spanish?
I do.
Yo hablo español?
No, I mean, shut up, Joe. Anybody here really speak Spanish besides Johnny Moon?
Does Jack of all trades give him
Tú eres una cabeza de mierda?
I'd say I'd give you basic phrases.
Okay.
I know a little bit.
Like you know, bañe, bathroom.
Me tengo que ir al baño. ¿Dónde está la cerveza, por favor?
Anybody who's ever worked in a...
¿Dónde está el bibliotec?
Anybody who's ever worked in a company knows that basura is trash.
Yes.
Well, we did bring our smartphones, correct?
Correct. You have no signal.
I see.
We downloaded the English to Spanish translator app before, but we don't need it.
No hay muchos problemas con este pescado.
Something about you don't like fish?
I'm very sorry that there is a fish on your nose, and it's very troubling to see that on your nose, and I hope that it won't be of any further trouble.
Stop copying Tyrion. Stop copying Tyrion's Valyrian.
Who's Tyrion's Valyrian?
Didn't you... If you
oh, that's right, Nostril, I forgot.
So Dr. Chad says, I'm going to go see about our additional transportation, because Dr. Vandekamp was supposed to meet us here, but I don't see him. I'm going to see what I can find out where he is or whatever.
Music. Dun, dun,
dun. Go on in the general store, and then we'll meet over at the restaurant for a quick snack before we head out. It's like 1 o'clock now. It's going to be a good 4 or 5 hour ride up to the site. So, you know, get what you need.
The supplies we need.
Any supplies you need, and then like I said, I'll meet you over there, and the university will buy you lunch.
Pitons.
I want the machete.
La tienda.
Is that tender?
All right, so you head on over to the general store. Tell me what you want, and I'll tell you if they have it.
$75 is like 8 billion pesos.
Yeah.
I have a very important thing I need to purchase. It's crucial. It's absolutely crucial to our mission. Señor, ¿tiene any sunscreen? I need SPF 50. SPF 50. Have you got any sunscreen? I burn very easily. My skin is not prepared for this kind of sun.
Yes.
See.
And he points over to the display where there's three different sunscreens. Right. 25, 35, and 50.
Where's that sunscreen on the huge display?
Bingo. Yeah. Over there on the shelf, eh?
Edison buys like $10 worth of sunscreen, blowing 1/7 of his budget.
That means it's more than you could carry down there.
I was going to say, that's the whole display. We're in Mexico.
He buys a lot of sunscreen.
I look for some nuts, basically.
Some stacks?
Joe Diffie's right there.
Cashews.
You're surrounded by them.
All right, so you find some trail mix.
What kind of nuts are you looking for?
You find some trail mix.
Anybody?
These
nuts.
Edison, what did you bring? Did you bring a sleeping bag, anything like that?
No. Edison did not bring a sleeping bag, but he did bring an extra battery pack for his phone.
Okay.
And that's it.
Did he bring a change of underwear?
Why would I need that?
I brought a pack that I could sleep on.
Okay. A little blanket. Okay. Juan Lowe, did you bring anything?
Yeah, Juan Lowe brought a sleeping bag.
Joe Diffie?
Yeah, I brought my backpack with my sleeping bag.
Oh, yeah, I've got my duffel bag.
His city slicker sleeping bag.
Change of clothes, change of...
I said we were buying a sleeping bag. So
Joe Diffie, being a city slicker, has a sleeping bag that's good to 20 below.
Well, you never know, man. It can get cold up here in the mountains at night.
Ford, did you bring anything relevant?
Oh, yes. I have binoculars, my laptop, my smartphone, sleeping bag, and a flashlight.
Ooh, flashlight. Somebody came prepared.
I have a compass.
Pocket knives?
On my phone.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, pocket knife as well. It's an all-inclusive knife. It's one of the Swiss Army's.
I have a rope.
Okay.
I was
going to
say, I'm in the general store thing. We should look for rope.
All right, so you're able to buy a
50 feet of hemp rope?
30 feet of very rough nylon rope.
Oh, it's
actually nylon.
They don't just have hemp and silk. Those are the only two options.
It's nylon. Everything's nylon now.
Oh my gosh.
I got a half shovel. One of the shovels I pulled up.
Oh, and a trench tool?
Anybody have a lighter?
Yes. Joe Diffie has plenty of
Joe
lighters.
Joe Diffie makes sure he has a lighter.
Senor, oh my gosh.
He's got plenty of lighters and medicinal materials.
He looks at Joe Diffie and he points him in the back corner where all the booze is.
There you go.
And there's
Joe's snack.
The giant bottle of tequila with the worm.
There it is.
For 100 pesos, which is like 22 cents.
Have you got any more rotten, like charcoal or charcoal pencils? Because
paper.
If we run out of pencils to write with, our mission is ruined.
Well, we won't get the XP for the night.
Well, I don't know what that means. Yeah.
Stop medding. He has some pencils and tracing paper.
Edison seems very proud of himself for purchasing extra supplies, as if he was saving patients in the
home. Okay, so Johnny Moon has purchased snacks, trail mix,
yeah.
Whatever.
Oh, yep. I look for a canteen.
Ooh, canteen? Yeah, he's got a couple of different canteens. One that goes over the shoulder and one that hooks on a belt. He has the belt, too.
I take the belt one.
I'll just buy a bottle of water.
Okay.
Do you have any of those fridge magnets that are really tiny bottles of tequila? I'd like to send one home to my mom. That'd be pretty cool.
No.
Oh, you got any postcards?
There's a little rack.
Oh, right.
There's like five postcards on the whole rack that we should hold like 200.
Which one should I pick?
Wish you were here. It shows a pool. You're out in the middle of nowhere.
Guadalajara.
California is
wonderful.
Edison agonizes over the choice of five postcards.
Chris, anything else? Anything you're looking for?
I always carry some lock picks, which nobody knows about.
All right. Mikey, you got anything else you're looking for?
Yeah, so Joe's going to grab some snacks, a flashlight, a bottle of water, a big bottle of water, and what else?
So you're looking at the prices. And everything is completely same until you get to the flashlight. That's like $14. Yeah. Gouge.
I'll get an extra bottle of water.
You'll have, I mean, those of you who have smartphones that will maintain a charge will have a light in that regard.
Also, sir, I'm very sorry for the loss of your people. I understand that Sabado Gigante has been canceled and will soon be going off the air in about 3 months.
Yeah, after like 440 years. He's trying to carry conversation. Where are you going? What are you here for?
Well, I'm not going to see Sabado Gigante. I just wanted to offer my condolences. That's all. Don't get me wrong.
Where are you going?
We're going to the agricultural dig.
Edison is here to study the history of Santa Ana.
Up top?
Yeah. Well, can you tell us about that?
And his wife is there, and you can tell she's immediately...
Did she drop something that breaks?
No, but she's immediately extremely uncomfortable with the whole conversation. And you hear her mumble something about Buddha.
Buddha?
Buddha, yeah.
If you... Never mind. Would Edison recognize that with his limited knowledge?
Give me a common knowledge check. So just give me your intelligence check. Yeah. Smarts check. God, I had to think of the words.
You said intelligence. I knew what you meant. Yeah.
Six.
So, you succeed. Eight. So yes, you know what it means.
End of race.
So, guys, I'm pretty sure that she said Bruja. That means witch. Is that what you were going for?
And she runs into the back room and comes out with a big, gaudy necklace with a cross on it, and she puts it on Edison.
Oh,
hey, is that mortals?
Well, I thank you very much, but I don't know if I have the money for this.
No, booyah, booyah!
No, but...
No!
Okay, thank you, miss. Thank you. Gracias. Gracias a usted.
And she mumbles something else, but you don't get it, what she said.
Okay.
Guys, look what I got. Isn't this cool?
You look nice.
I kind of feel like a gangster. You guys are like my peeps.
Like a ganger banger.
Yeah, we're going to go on the bus and we're going to roll. All
right, so Dr. Chad comes back. He goes, I don't know what happened to Dr. Vanderkamp, but I know where we're going. I got us some transportation. Let's go get a quick bite and then we're going to get out of here. Because, like I said, it's a long run. It's a long ride to get there.
I hope they have Italian food here.
Should we, Professor? Should we call someone to let them know that Vanderkamp didn't leave us? Because reception is not good, but there might be a phone here, so we can let somebody know that we didn't rendezvous.
I know him. He's probably all distracted and forgot about us.
All right.
It's not uncommon for him to be lost in his work. You know.
Should we leave a message on his voicemail? Let him know that we showed
up. Up there, there's no signal.
But then, at least when
so he had no way to get in touch with us.
When he gets a signal, he can see that we tried.
Yeah, but he wouldn't get it until he came down here. Then we're gonna pass him on the road. This is gonna be the road like you've never been on, son.
Oh, you know, I played pole position on the Atari. Is it like that?
Is there still Dramamine in this store?
There is no Dramamine.
Poor Edison.
Dr. Chad, could you leave a message for
I'll leave a note with the storekeep.
Yes.
So he takes you over to the restaurant. They have rice and beans, pork,
and tortillas.
I'll take some carnitas and some rice and beans.
Wait, food's paid for. I'll take one of everything.
Chris and I have this.
Ford's taking some pictures of the place. Just so you know.
I am reminded, Chris and I, this past February, visited our Uncle Eddie in Puerto Rico, where he took us to the Pork Highway, which is a series of...
It's a road paved with pork?
It's road stands. It's like side carts, road stands that's been for a mile, and all they sell is like pork products, like fried pork, like you name it, all the worst, greasiest...
So literally like Forrest Gump with pork.
Yes. Instead of shrimp, it's pork?
Pork.
That's exactly what it was.
Pork.
Was it good, Chris?
It was heaven, man. So good.
Alrighty. So you have your
pork wrapped in bacon, wrapped in pork.
Pork wrapped in bacon, wrapped in.
It's kind of like that email, Josh, you sent with the ballpark food.
Yeah, right?
Oh, my God.
Some of those are good, and some of those are just downright scary. The ballpark food.
Reading it.
Yeah.
Yeah, good stuff there. All right, so... So you guys come out and Dr. Chad has your bus there.
Oh, we got a picture of the bus. Is it the magic school bus? Can you scroll to the left? Oh,
it's pretty close.
Wheels on the bus. Well,
it's a Tempe. It's a Tempe.
They go round and round until they fall off. Look at
them. They go round and round, but not no more than that.
It looks like a school bus from like 1945 in the U.S. that made it down to Mexico and is still in use today.
It was the sixth ever bus in Mexico, obviously.
It is a beat up, like, if this bus could tell stories, it's seen some stuff. It has seen some stuff.
Yeah, it's seen better days, but let's get it going here.
Do you need us to push?
It runs.
Does the bus have air conditioning, sir? You think we could turn it on for this last?
Yeah, you know what the air conditioning is, son?
Yeah.
You roll down the window. Oh wait, the windows don't roll. You just open the window.
Oh.
There are no windows.
There might not be any windows.
Mikey, were you gonna say something, man?
I was gonna say your air conditioning consists of the fact that there are no windows.
So you climb onto the bus, get ready.
Do we have to strap on a luggage up on top?
No, it fits in the back because there's room for. Oh. I mean, there's only the.
What's our driver?
Dr. Chad's driving.
Oh, we also start telling stories on the trip. So we tell Ford Prefect some of the interesting stuff that's happened to us, or at least Edison does. He rambles on
and
he talks about the Needler. And how mysterious he was, and how Johnny Moon actually saw the Needler, and the fire that they
Johnny Moon's just with Missy.
And how they saved people in the auditorium on the first day, and how they have free pizza for a week, so he fills them all in.
All right.
More than he ever
does. Did we lose our free pizza this week, or is it roll over?
You ate
Ford,
it already.
Ford mentions, Ford mentions he missed the coverage on most of those. He did cover, I don't know if you're all aware or knew about the missing pilot that was found outside of ETU. Anybody know about that?
What?
I wrote the article. Yeah, I wrote the article.
You wrote the article? You wrote the school newspaper?
It was an article about 2 weeks ago. Yeah, in the school newspaper. I'm also the editor-in-chief.
You're an editor. You're a freshman. You're an editor.
I'm an editor.
I saw the school newspaper once. It was in the bathroom. I used it to, you know.
Huh.
Read while you're taking a dump?
Well, there was no more TP, and the guy next to me couldn't spare a square, so...
So what happened to this pilot? Did he die when he crashed?
No, he was found wandering near the ETU. Just dazed, didn't know how he got there. Interesting story.
I'll say, what happened to his
plane? I dabbled in a little...
Chris, did you lose you?
I think Chris got...
Oh, yeah, no, it glitches out, so I thought it was just paused. No, he's unexplained. We still haven't figured out what happened. You know, and I, back for where I am from in Houston, I did a little bit of investigational work with my mentor, which brings me here, and I did as much research as I could and couldn't find out a thing.
Well, that's strange. At least it seems like we all seem just weird, strange things going on at East Texas University.
That's what kind of brings me here, as a matter of fact.
Also, the promise of a good education and a well-paying job, right?
Excuse me.
Veggies.
Those don't count. I mean, they're veggies.
All right, so the bus ride is through the middle of nowhere. It seems to go on forever. It's only about 4 or 5 hours. You notice a slight incline, it's starting to get a little darker, you know, so it's starting to settle a little bit.
Most of the Aztec stuff is in the jungles. This is interesting that it's out in the desert.
Actually, it's up a mountain.
Spooky!
Well, it's actually not that strange. Well, Assatopa, I don't know if you're all aware, I did a little bit of research before we did come down, which was likely a settlement of the specific Zapotec lineage. I don't know if you all knew that, did a little research before I came down, but they have been known to come up this far.
What the hell are you talking about?
Wow, that is fascinating.
Do they come up by land or do they come up through the water?
Well, they came up by land and drank the water.
So it gets more forested as you go up. The road gets really narrow. There are parts, you know, you see those scary pictures on the internet where it's one lane, kind of.
Yeah,
you're there. Dr. Chad is brushing the bus against the mountain in places because he's scared too.
Not enough, I think. Fort, did I hear you say you were from Houston?
I am from Houston.
Oh, one Lord Montgomery is from Houston too. Not him,
really?
Yes.
You better find it, damn it.
One law.
Well, Houston's a large city.
Yeah, very big city. So I just thought, are you from the east side of Houston?
Actually from the west side of Houston. I was a student at the University of Houston for about 2 months before I moved here.
Oh, yeah. See, I was on the east side of Houston, and I came straight to ETU. So that's probably why we never saw
each other.
Well, no, did you ever live
what church you go to?
What church? I did not go to church.
Well, why did you not go to church?
I do my studying at home.
God is where the heart is, Juan Lo.
No, God is in the church. You gotta go to church and worship God. That's what my foster parents told me.
Juan Lo, did you ever live in China first and then go to Houston?
Yeah,
wait a minute, you're Chinese? 16.
He's, Juan Lo is Chinese.
Oh, he hasn't seen the picture?
I thought he was Puerto Rican.
He's not working.
Oh.
Is it
different kind of
Juan?
That's what I thought.
Mm.
Was actually
the name of Juan. He's more like a wonton rapper instead of Don Juan.
He's not very
Juan Martinez.
Yes. Holy frijoles.
My name is Juan.
Juan Lo is definitely not the world's most interesting man. Let's put it that way.
I don't know.
He cannot grow a beard to save his life.
I'm pretty sure I saw Juan Lo do some pretty interesting moves back on opening day in freshman. I think there's a depth of character and skill to this man, and he's not telling us the entire story. He's a man of international mystery and intrigue.
Women want him and men want
him. You are so full of shit, your eyes are brown.
All right, Chris, I'm sending you an email called Yearbook. That'll show you the pictures the five guys have chosen for themselves, and we'll need one from you at some point.
Just note that Juan Lo, that was a picture taken when Juan Lo first got off the boat. He doesn't dress like that anymore.
Gotcha.
Let us know when you get it. You can laugh.
Definitely, Joe Diffie definitely dresses like his character.
Hey, you guys seem like an interesting bunch. Mind if I tag along with you?
Well, the more the merrier, I say.
Well, seeing as there's only seven of us.
Yeah, Tony seems to be spending all this time full court press on Joy, trying to get anything. And he's getting some, he's trying to melt through the ice.
What is Juan? Is he gay with that V-neck?
Holy God. That's how they dressed in Hong Kong.
Alrighty.
Remember, they're about 20 years behind the time. They just got the internet.
Yeah, it was the action hero star.
Bruce Lee.
No.
I mean, it's
Jackie Chan.
Jackie Chan.
Oh, Jackie Chan. That's right. A younger Jackie Chan.
Yeah, younger Jackie Chan.
That's
in a fishnet shirt.
I remember that. And then Joe Diffie is Ferris Bueller.
Yep.
I think during the parade.
Yes.
Yeah.
The parade.
So who's the muscle guy?
The muscle guy was your dorm guy, the guy in charge of the dorm.
That's right. Okay.
Your RA.
And Johnny Moon was younger Marlon Brando?
William Shatner.
William Shatner, that's right.
Jeff's out. He doesn't have to go to school tomorrow.
Hey, he was up early today, last day of school.
He got up late today.
He said he got up late today.
Oh, late for him, late for me.
And then you see Boz.
Jeff is sleeping already?
Yeah.
Nope.
He's struggling over there. That's because he brought a lot of beer tonight. Nope.
We didn't even finish it.
That's for you tomorrow, man. You only have one kid home tomorrow. You better.
Oh my gosh, there's so much Netflix you could get into.
Anyway, so the bus finally makes it up to the camp. You're definitely Unless you've climbed the mountain, you're pretty high. You know, your view is pretty expansive.
Joe's always pretty high.
Joe's pretty high for sure.
You arrive at the campsite. You don't see any kind of ruin or archaeological, you know, excavation or dig going on. And Dr. Chad explains that, you know, this is the best place for us to make camp. The dig is about a 15 or 20 minute hike up the mountain further up. But this was the flattest, safest spot for us to camp.
Dr. Chad.
There's another bust like his. It's similar condition. There's five tents, one screened in one, so they probably keep some food. There's a fire, but it's out. There's some knockdown chairs set up, that kind of stuff.
Sir, I've got a very important question.
There is one thing that Edison immediately notices.
What's that?
There's no porta potty. There's no bathroom.
That's exactly what I was going to ask. How did you know I was going
to
ask that?
I have a note to myself about that.
So, sir, is there a porta potty, a place that we can go? Have you set up an outhouse, maybe? Built it in your spare time?
Hey, Coach East, where's that shovel you got?
I was just going to give him the shovel.
You want some
atomic chili? No, I want to go home. This is horrible. This is not humane conditioning at all. Nobody told me we'd be doing this. This is horrible. These conditions are dreadful.
Dr. Chad
Edison,
does...
You want to be really careful when you dig that hole and squat over it. You don't want a scorpion to sting your ding-ding.
Wait, there's scorpions out here?
Hey, I don't know anyone
who has ding-ding. Scorpions that can sting my ding-ding? I did not sign up for this.
So... Dr. Chad seems a little concerned that there's nobody there.
It's just like a ghost camp.
It's empty. It's going to start. It's pretty dark now. It's starting to maybe it's October, so maybe 6:30 or so. It's pretty dark out. You know, you guys got up there. You needed the headlights to get up there. So he's guessing. You know, they must have got carried away up there, and they're just finishing up or wrapping up. You know, lanterns and that kind of stuff. So hopefully they'll be down soon enough.
Edison, you mentioned that some of the chairs were knocked over.
Not down, I said. Me and I think you fold them up. Oh, so, okay. I mean, the camp is set up.
It's neat. It's not disheveled.
Correct.
Okay. No evidence of a struggle.
That's correct. What I'm asking.
There's room in the tents for you guys to spread out a little bit.
Have we eaten yet?
Not dinner.
Well, guys, I don't know about you, but I could eat a horse. How about dinner?
That's like sacred down here. Edison. Don't be saying that to the natives.
Oh, I see what you mean. I'm very hungry, and
it's kind of like saying to an Indian, "Hey, that cow looks delicious."
Yeah, you're right.
There is a little stream near there, so you get some fresh water.
If you got to go to the bathroom, go downhill.
Hey, I read somewhere that it's not a good idea to drink water in Mexico. I think we have to boil the water before we take it from the stream. If I'm not mistaken.
Dr. Chats is here. He gives you a packet of iodine pills.
Oh. Thank you.
This will make your water taste terrible, but you can drink it.
All right, thank you, sir.
Or you can boil it.
Set up camp and have dinner. Disagree?
Yeah.
Agree.
Okay.
All right. So you set up. The camp is there. Nobody brought a tent, so I'm assuming you're just going to reuse the tents that they have there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
There's some basic food stuffs. I mean, there's not a ton of food there.
Hey, Mr. Taggart. I mean, Mr. Chad. Hey, can we have some more beans for dinner?
Joe, we got to save this. I don't know. We didn't bring that much, and I thought they'd have more left. So they opened some canned foods, heated stuff up. Nothing spectacular.
Sir, I'm noticing a worrying lack of marshmallows and chocolate and graham crackers, and I was under the impression that there might be s'mores on this trip.
S'more what?
No, s'mores. I would like s'mores.
S'more? No, I told you we have to save the food.
No, I thought that we'd be getting s'mores. He doesn't understand.
I do. I'm just giving you a hard time.
I know.
he says that the professor says, I know.
Oh.
We're here to work.
Well, a man does not subsist on charcoal etchings alone.
Mm-hmm.
You know, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow we die. That was in Robin Hood. That was a really good movie. Prince of Thieves. Brian Adams did the soundtrack. It was really good.
I see. I heard Kevin Costner's accent was spot on, too.
Unlike other Robin Hoods, I can speak with an English accent. He's a smoothie.
I know.
never saw Men in Tights.
Oh my goodness! Yes, it's Mel Brooks.
I've only seen parts of that. So he
Mike knows.
Dr. Chad says, you know, guys, we'll get an early start. I'm turning in. Hang out by the fire all you want, and we'll see you in the morning.
What everybody else?
I'm assuming they're up at the dig, but it's too dark to go up there now.
It's like 8 o'clock at night.
It's too dark to go up there. Yeah, I'm assuming they're just staying up there. Maybe, I don't know.
Do you guys have like walkie-talkies so you can communicate at the camp?
I don't see any down here, so they must have them all up there.
Oh, are you a little worried that they're not back yet? Like, do they have a second camp? Is this like a base camp?
I'm a little worried, but Dr. Man, the camp is a little. What's the word I'm looking for? He can get preoccupied real easy, easily distracted, easily obsessed.
He does have the word camp in his name, so yeah. That's reassuring.
Then the camp like fish sticks, right?
Yes, that's right.
And as he's getting ready to turn in, you hear a howl out in the woods. Everybody give me a... Jeff. Everybody who's ever been outside and spent the night out there, give me a common sense roll, which is probably just Jeff. Probably just Johnny Moon.
Juan Lowe may be tough, but he's a city boy.
Hey, I may be from the city, but my parents took us camping.
Common sense. Just use a smarts check.
Smarts check.
Okay, Mikey, I need you. You can give me your smarts check, too. Yeah. You need a raise. Jeff needs a success. So Johnny Moon looks a little uncomfortable because he doesn't recognize it. It's not a coyote or a wolf or anything.
Chupacabra.
I got a 7.
Yeah, you needed a raise to know that. Because you were not as much as he was.
I exploded, and then I got a roll, and then I rolled a 1.
Oh. I hate when that happens. So,
did you prematurely explode?
Oh.
Every time.
Joe has that problem on a frequent basis when he's in the reefer.
it's around you. You can't really, you have to wander out into the dark. It's up to you if you want to do that.
Don't leave the fire, Cochise. It's a chupacabra. Out, right?
I grab
a notice check.
Flashlight.
I didn't buy a flashlight.
I grab his phone.
Waffle goes with his phone.
I have a flip phone.
One logo. How
about, can we do a notice
back
check?
To the...
The fire limits your ability to see anything. If you want to leave the ring of fire, then we'll do another notice check. It sounds like Cochise and Juan Lowe are going.
The ring of fire.
It was nice knowing you guys.
Hey, it's not a zombie apocalypse, and they're still playing by the rules.
Hey, if we're not back in 5 minutes, you know what to do, right?
You know what? Ford's going to go.
Wait another 5 minutes?
Exactly.
He's got a flashlight.
Ford's going to go too?
Ford's going. He seems to be extremely curious.
Ooh. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, Edison's really curious too. He is totally going.
Oh, you see that?
Joe grabs the chair that Juan Lowe was sitting in, grabs it, throws his feet up on it, and says, all right, you guys let me know if you need me. I'll be right here.
I got my flashlight on.
Do you guys think that could be like an escaped tiger from the zoo?
Edison, we're in the middle of nowhere.
Well, that's exactly where I was.
Where would you see a zoo that tiger would be escaped from?
Well, a successfully escaped tiger knows to run out away
from
people
escaped.
Into the middle of nowhere. You know, this is the perfect place for an escaped tiger.
Does Juan Lowe go to Adam?
Actually, you know what, Edison? That makes perfect sense. Why don't you go with the idea that that's an escaped tiger?
Okay.
Once Juan Lowe sees everybody else getting ready to go, he hangs back to keep an eye on the camp.
Okay, so Juan Lowe and Joe Diffie are hanging out by the fire with Trout.
And
And the remaining three of you.
Isn't there a couple of girls at camp, too?
Yeah, Tony Hoffman and Joy Hines turned in when Dr. Chad did.
Which type of Joe go? Joy
go to? Both of them went into the tent with Dr. Chad.
Oh, I see how it is.
So apparently she went in there for safety and he went in there because he wasn't going to sleep by himself. That was also the largest empty tent. So there's four other tents, each with a spot or two available. Of course, you could just bunch other people's shit up. That's up to you.
Yeah, they're not coming back tonight. As a matter of fact, they're probably not coming back.
So Cochise, Wanlo, and Edison head off into the darkness.
And Ford Prefect.
And Ford.
Not Wanlo.
Not Wanlo. Wanlo and Joe Diffie and Trout tend the fire to make sure it doesn't go out.
So we're basically taking the party and breaking them into two groups and separating them.
It's almost like there's a split in the party.
Yes. Joe, did you buy that bottle of tequila, and are you passing that around now?
Oh, Joe, absolutely, Greg. I was just, you know, Josh, that is so funny. I was just about to say, Joe opens up the bottle of tequila that he bought from his backpack.
The one with the worm in it.
Absolutely.
Hey, it's
but he's saving the worm for Edison.
And Edison will probably drink it.
Peer pressure.
Exactly. He is absolutely saving that worm for Edison.
All right, so Cochise, Edison, and Ford, please give me a notice check at -2 because of the darkness.
Good thing I have a +2.
Notice at -2, Jeff.
Does it give you notice you're rolling?
Notice the D, yeah.
I got a 4.
I got a 1.
With your -2, you got a 4?
Oh, 2.
Snake eyes.
Edison trips over a root.
Oh!
Falls down.
Distracts everybody.
Damages his glasses.
Are we supposed to roll two die?
You get your D6 wild die, and then if you have a notice skill, you get the notice skill.
I forgot that. Snake eyes.
He pulls you down too.
What?
Dinging your camera.
Ooh. Oh, my perfect camera. Dang it.
Sorry, yes. I didn't see. I'm sorry. I just kind of slipped there. I thought it was solid ground, but it was kind of not solid ground.
It was...
No worries.
Is that pretty flat here?
It was animal dung.
Ooh. Oh, do you guys smell something bad?
And it wasn't... I'm going to wait for Cochise to come back. Jeff is relieving himself in multiple ways. So.
Sorry about that there, Ford. I'm pretty handy with fixing things, though. I might be able to fix that camera for you if there's any serious damage.
You tripped over a pile of poo?
Well, if you can take a peek at it, I appreciate it.
Sure thing.
So it turns out that when looking around and trying to pick up Edison, he slipped on some poo. Cochise, want to examine that, see if you recognize it as anything?
I love poo.
Well, you might recognize it, what kind of animal it is.
I have investigation.
That would be great if you were looking it up on the internet.
Wait a minute, doesn't he just bend over, like take a bite, you know, swish it around
tracking
a little bit?
Tracking notice, investigation.
I'll give you a tracking roll. See if you recognize kind of the animal it is. What kind of prints are around, if any.
It's squishy like that, it's carnivorous.
Edison is with a stick trying to get it all off of his boot.
And the pants.
Do you have boots?
No, not boots. What would he have?
Double ones.
Tennis shoes?
Double ones.
Alright.
Oh my god, dude. All three of you guys roll double ones?
Yes.
Yep.
Jeff rolled a double one on his track check. The other two rolled double ones on their water through the dark track.
So are they like covered in poo?
Uh-oh, Jeff's got 3 explosions so far. Is he going to get 4?
13.
Wow.
13. You don't recognize the poo. It definitely seems to be from a carnivorous animal.
What does it taste like? Oh, wait.
Poo. There are tracks all over. Certainly well more than one animal. Whatever it is. And you hear the howl. And you hear the howl again. Ooh! And then, just to send shivers up your spine, a horrible cackling laugh.
From Edison.
No,
just kidding.
No. Horrible cackling laugh. Even the guys by the fire feel the shiver run up their spine.
Guys, I think we should...
Everybody give me a fear check +2.
What is a fear check?
Is it spirit, maybe?
I forget what fear is. It's a... It is a...
Probably tied to spirit.
Campaign rule. Hold on a second. Probably tied to spirit.
I don't have a skill of fear.
He's looking it up.
What was that you were saying there, Dick?
You can call it a spirit roll +2.
Okay. Edison got 12.
Ready?
Shake it off.
Go. I got 9. I got a 14.
13.
Everybody did well.
Safety in numbers.
Yeah.
Aren't you guys good that you both upped your spirit for this game?
So you all definitely get the shiver down your spine. Those of you with experience in this kind of stuff shake it off and realize, I've seen shit that'll turn you white. And you think you could take whatever it is.
Am I picking anything up with the flashlight?
Give me a notice check. I mean, it's dark, and you're in unfamiliar territory.
I got a 4 plus 2, 6.
Six.
That doesn't explode, right?
No.
Only when you get the max.
On the die.
All right, 6.
Where do you get the plus 2 from?
That's my notice. I got a plus 2.
Okay, notice. You're not adding the dice together.
No, he has a static bonus to his notice.
Okay, you only add the dice together for damage. So
he rolled a 4 and then he added 2.
No, I got it. I'm just making sure. So, yeah. I mean, you see what Cochise has pointed out. A lot of animal prints. You don't recognize the print. Might be a dog, wolf kind of thing. Definitely a quadruped. Ooh, give myself a body for that word.
I'm gonna snap a couple pictures of it.
I said quadrupedal.
What, Chris?
I'm gonna snap a couple pictures of it. That's what I do.
All right. The howl comes from the other side of the campfire this time. Whatever it is, it seems to be circling.
All right, let's get our backs to the campfires.
can
look
out
into the distance.
Maybe we could just get in the bus and then, drive away and then come back in the morning.
We should all get in the bus.
It seems like the bus is better than the campfire, no? How about we move the bus next to the campfire and then get in the bus?
Are we back at the...
How about we wake up the professor?
All right, so you go back to the fire? You never got more than like 20 feet away from the fire, 15 feet away from the fire.
Guys, I think we should definitely go back to the fire. Right now.
We go back to the fire.
All right, you go back to the fire. Professor comes out. He's like, what's going on? You notice he has a gun. It's a six-shooter.
All right, explain what I saw with the dirt. We heard a cackling. We heard a howl.
Cackling, that's something. We've heard the howls before, but never a cackling laugh. Is this somebody out there fooling around, you think?
We're all here.
Unless it's somebody from Dr. Vandekamp.
Nah, Vandekamp doesn't have a lot of humor for that stuff.
See my shoe? That's a kind of poop Johnny Moon says is from a ferocious monster that eats humans for breakfast and for dinner.
But it's carnivore.
You really are special, aren't you?
What? Are you looking at the
shoe? You are really a special individual.
Well, my parents thought I was special in 5th grade, and then they advanced me 2 years to 7th grade, so maybe I'm
not. Okay. All right, let's stoke the fire up a little bit.
And then we get in the bus. And then we sleep in the bus with the protection of the metal of the bus, right?
Except there's no windows in the bus.
Well, we can take off the hood and then jerry-rig it to fortify the bus from whatever creatures exist.
Two windows? You close up two windows?
Well...
How high up are the windows?
You lay on the ground.
5 feet up, maybe? 4 feet up?
Well, it looks like... That's 6 feet.
That's a Mexican, dude. He's shorter than you.
Oh, damn. This means like Bob's
This is so offensive.
Sorry, I didn't mean to offend anybody. I just have to make the bus work for me.
Beat me to it.
What was that, Mike? Can't beat you to it?
Beat me to that one.
Ford likes the idea of, he says, hey, whatever it is, it's better than being on the ground.
Well, why don't we take turns so everybody can get some rest tonight? We can have two people on watch, and then everybody else can sleep.
That sounds like a good idea there, Joe Diffie.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Chad says he's gonna hang out on top of the bus with the gun with all the groups. He may doze off a little bit, but keep an eye on him. He's not comfortable giving the gun to anybody else because he is the adult and is responsible for everybody.
Do you have any other weapons, sir?
Whatever you look around, I see some big sticks. They might be able to find a shovel over there in the supply tent.
Maybe we should all get ourselves a nice, big, heavy thing just in case.
I think some long sticks, we take our pocket knives, sharpen them up as spears.
Is there a tire iron and a jack for the bus?
This is Mexico, man. Are you kidding me? You're lucky the tires are still on it.
You're lucky there's still tires while you were parked there.
Well, the tires are there, but the hubcaps are gone.
Dude, the bus came over the border. The hubcaps were gone before they got a mile in. They've been gone for 30 years.
They never stopped.
Oh, guys, you know what? We're fine. I just realized I have this app here, and it plays the noises of ferocious predators to scare off other people. So I've got this one, which is the spotted jackal tiger of Africa, of Eastern Africa, and I just hit play here, and it shows what it sounds like, and that should scare off whatever's...
Did you press play?
Edison presses play. It sounds like this. Wait.
And there's a response from the dark, from multiple directions, of our... You know, a howlish, roarish.
I think whatever animal make that
and
sound.
You better shut that phone up now, or I'm gonna smash it.
I think we should get in the bus.
All right, Dr. Chad, like, all right, let's everybody move toward the bus.
Hey, Edison, can I see your phone?
He's bringing up the rear.
Here, yeah, of course. Here,
oh, thank you.
You guys, you're getting in the bus. You hear him scream out loud. The gun goes off.
Oh my gosh.
Here we go.
Turn around with the flashlights on. What do we see?
You see something clamped onto his arm, and as you shine the lights on it, it breaks off and runs off into the and runs off.
Talk about grab him and bring him to the bus.
I was gonna say, I'm not heroic.
Edison helps.
I'm loyal.
Edison's just curious.
Code of honor.
He's bleeding pretty good from the arm. He was smart enough, lucky enough, whatever, to hold on to the gun.
Oh, good.
Thank you.
Adam, this is...
I'm done now.
Are you sure?
Yes. So he's still holding on to the gun. He's bleeding pretty good. Anybody have a healing skill?
Edison does.
I can pray.
He's got a D6 healing. It looks like we got it. That thing's bleeding pretty hard. We got to stop that bleeding.
There is no first aid kit. There's no first aid kit in the bus. There's a first aid kit in the tent.
Guys, we need that first aid kit right away.
You're a minus two without the first aid kit. Considering the circumstances, you're a minus two.
Okay, that's fair. Well,
I take this gun.
What do you think you're doing?
Maybe where's your medical kit?
He's bleeding a lot. Whatever got an artery or something. He's not fighting.
Well, if he got an artery, that he don't need a first aid kit. He needs a surgeon.
I think I'm going to roll the healing check.
Can somebody help him with the healing check?
Does anybody else have healing at all?
He's the doctor. He probably does.
Anybody here, is anybody here pre-med?
You guys figure it out for a second.
So the question is, do we go with the minus two, or do you risk more lives trying to get the first aid kit?
I think with the wooden men, we'll stop it.
We wouldn't be able to stop Coaches.
Yeah, he's heroic.
He is heroic. But we can get somebody to compress the wounds while we go out there and try to get it and come back.
I take my belt off and I wrap it around his arm and I make a makeshift tourniquet to try to control the bleed. Letting the pressure off every 10 minutes until you guys get back.
Mike, I think it is awesome that you, having been a professional paramedic, you're stuck giving, like, the most basic response.
I had to think about it for a second, Bob. I was like, shit, what do I do, man? I don't have my bag with me.
Nana, who crocheted.
By the way, do you know they changed our protocols, Mike? We're now allowed to give tourniquets?
Yes.
Mikey, you remember me to tell you what we saw on the...
Totally unrelated, but...
Yes, no.
I'm going to share that pain.
It's not Roxanne, dude. No, nothing could be worse than Roxanne.
I don't know, that's close.
It's unrelated now.
Mikey, remember me to tell you what we saw on Memorial Day at my in-laws. But anyway, Dr. Chad says, listen, There might be other stuff in the supply tent. There's probably a couple machetes.
All right.
And definitely a shovel or two. And then there's first aid in the tent next to it, which was his tent.
We get Missy to apply pressure to the wounds. I think Joe did.
Tony and Joy are useless. They're cowering in the back of the bus.
So we
need some lights, and we need some numbers here to grab stuff.
I'm with you. I'm right with you. We got to come back quick. He's losing blood quickly.
I have a D4 shooting. Anybody else have anybody else a good shot?
I have a D6 shooting.
I watch some YouTube videos, and I know that...
All right. Here, Joe. You take the gun. I got you back.
Wanlo, you got a shooting?
Nope. That's why I didn't hit anything.
Edison
There's five bullets, Mikey.
Got it.
Edison opens up his phone, the flashlight app.
Joe, you want me to grab your phone? You have a flashlight on it?
I got a flashlight, and I got the gun, and I'm ready to go. I give Wanlo instructions. Is Wanlo staying back?
No, he's going with you.
We're going.
Who's staying back to? You know what? The professor can manage the tourniquet with his good arm.
Tony Hoffman and Joy Hines and Missy are staying behind.
All right, so they can handle keeping the tourniquet tight on the professor's arm.
Yep.
Okay. All right, we're off.
Josh,
Trout's there as well.
Are you Missy? Yes.
Yeah, you're right. Trout's
useless.
Missy gives you some tongue back because she's afraid. She's keeping it cool, but you can tell she's definitely
She's a cool girl.
Her tongue's a little dead fishy.
Hey guys, I'm thinking when we get back, we should ask for more than $75. I'm just saying, let's make a note. Let's put a pin on it for now, but let's come back to this. Okay?
Hey, does everybody know?
Edison, let's get that first.
Delivery player.
You're right, Joe.
What the hell are you talking about?
Wait, what did you say?
Okay. Does everybody know the Statue of Liberty player?
No.
Hey, guess what? Let's deal some cards.
You mean the statue in New York City?
Bob was asking for some combat, so I'm giving you guys some combat finally.
It's over here.
It's all right there, Bob.
Oh, look at that.
Almost like he knew it was.
I did ask for combat last session, so I'm pretty happy about this. Even if my character is not good at fighting.
Does anybody have anything else?
Yeah,
I have like a hand knife.
Pocket knife? Yeah, I've always got a pocket knife too.
Edison has some very powerful suntan lotion, which can sting really bad if it gets in the eyes.
Is this an allergy medicine? Make it sleepy?
Okay, are we ready?
I'll blow antihistamine.
How many bad guy spaces would you like? Two, okay. Here we go.
Adam got the Joker.
Nice.
No, Joel.
Son of a gun. Oh, a double son of a gun.
Right here, buddy.
Would you like to describe the order, Josh?
Okay, so Juan Lowe drew the Joker. He'll be followed by Monster 2, who got a King of Hearts. Monster 1 got a Jack of Spades. And then it's Edison... Joe Diffie, reverse alphabetical, right?
Yeah, reverse alphabetical.
Then Ford, and lastly, Johnny Moon. That's probably the order in which you exited the bus. Getting your kiss goodbye.
Joshua, what?
If you don't mind topping it off, Bob, that would be great.
Adam, are you good? Would you like anything?
I'm good, thank you. Sorry, you need to be hogging it off.
All right. Johnny, Wanlo.
You can't see anything?
Can't see anything. You've run out of the range of the fire. So you can see the fire. Tents are moderately around it. You guys are probably 20 feet away. Thank you. At the bus. Right,
so Wanlo will step to the side and let other people out. Defer.
Good job doing nothing.
What are they gonna do?
With the Joker.
He's got a +2 to do nothing later.
Yep.
Wanlo comes out.
He can run at a +2.
And
Wanlo comes out and goes, which one is the supply tent?
And one of the dog like creatures just jumps right out of the darkness at you, pins you against the bus. Do you think? It's got you He's got a paw on each shoulder. It's chomping at your face. You're dodging, but it misses with a three.
Ooh. All right, well, Wanlo will react to that and try and...
So I'm going to... Because these creatures, there's more than one, have a higher roll than everybody, I'm going to disperse them through combat. I'm not going to have them all go at once.
So they're deferring.
They're deferring. Mm-hmm. This one is attacking first because he saw first.
Okay. Well, Wanlo is going to try and gut the one that's in front of him.
Okay.
Are they just wild dogs or they look like dogs?
They're definitely more than a dog.
Okay. Because that'd be really embarrassing if Edison just stepped in dog poo.
It's hard to see, it's still dark. You know,
it makes it better to know that it's.
Did you have a flashlight?
No. I got a six.
A six on your fighting roll?
Fighting.
Okay, it has a parry of six, so that's a hit.
So that's a hit. And what probably strength plus a d4?
Yeah.
Yes. What's my strength? Oh, wait a minute. I forgot that. Can I retcon that and say I just tried to punch him? And I wasn't using a weapon because I forgot that I have martial arts.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. He's a martial arts guy.
So I'm trying to kind of wrestle him off me and hit him and kick him and. I'm going to try. The dog's up on me like this. I'm going to try and kick him in the gym.
You do that. Go for the Jimmy. Go for the Jimmy.
Exploding, quivering heart move. Wanlo, exploding heart move.
Joy Hines, who's behind the open window where Wanlo, off the deep end, screaming hysterically, terrified beyond her capacity for rational thought. You smell urine. It's just, that's what it is.
Guys, the urine was actually...
Can I shoot her?
A little bit of all of us.
There's a little wet spot on my undies now.
Twelve.
You deck it. Wow. You connect clearly in the jimmies. You gonna give me some damage?
No, that was the damage.
Oh.
12 was the damage. Sorry, I thought I wasn't gonna try and retcon that hit roll.
Oh, okay. That's fine. So you fight, you hit, you hear a crunching noise. Yeah, it kind of scampers off into the woods.
Does it yelp? Does it supernatural?
Oh, it gives you a yelp that's not, it's sad.
So it can feel pain.
It's sad, it yelps. You definitely think you broke a rib or something on it. You know, as it wanders off, you see what almost looks like spikes sticking out of its back. Nobody else can see that. It's okay.
It doesn't make a difference.
it looks like it tries to scamper off, and it rolls under the ground. You can't see it because there's no real light.
Yeah.
But you can tell it didn't make it very far. Nice. You may have killed it.
I make a run for. Can I? I can still have my. I still can move now, right? So I will run for. I will. No, I can't run. I will move for towards the end.
Okay.
So, standard pace.
Standard pace. All right.
Because, you know, when you're being attacked by a pack of wolves of whatever, make sure you split up as much as possible.
That is exactly how we want it to be.
Oh, you know what? For A, one most in the city. So, yeah, fuck it. He does that.
Yeah, fuck it. He does that?
Yeah.
All right.
And it makes perfect sense to him. Go get something.
All right. The Joker card. A creature comes flying out of the darkness. Note the term flying. Attempts to tackle Wanlo and take a nibble out of him. Mm-hmm. So that is going to be... I'm going to call that a fighting. And it... I just have to succeed for fighting, right? Or I have to outdo your parry?
No, I tie. Tie is a hit.
I have five.
That's a hit.
All right. Five. So the creature... And you can see kind of, it seems like an old woman almost. Maybe, a haggy, kind of scary.
Harpy-ish, but humanoid, more humanoid?
Hag, scary, witchy kind of thing. Takes a chop out of your arm.
Ooh.
Dealing.
6 million points of damage.
No, it doesn't deal a lot of damage. It doesn't actually tell me how much damage it does, but this
is
something.
Hey guys, I think that's
status effects.
That's a brouhaha.
You're brilliant. You're brilliant, dude.
This whole thing is a brouhaha. Is what one mom would say. One saying, "Oh my God, what the hell is that?"
The problem is we have too much fun in game night for me to make it scary.
I know.
8 damage.
Let's see. My I have 5 toughness.
A little hot, huh?
So I'm shaken.
You are shaken. If you recover, per the new rules change, you can continue on without an issue next turn. There's no loss of turn if you make the shake and roll.
That's nice. Oh, you don't have to get the raise anymore.
Correct.
Nope. Gotcha. And that's spirit.
Correct.
Bigger would be a soak.
Correct.
Gotcha.
Correct.
All right.
Cool. All right, next up is Edison.
Edison has no weapons. He's got a smartphone and flashlight. And there's this witch creature. And
the witch creature almost sprung out of nowhere. It looked like it might have flown in. It took a bite out of Edison and is out of your sight already.
Wow.
I took a bite out of Wan Lo and is out of your sight already.
Is the other dog there anymore?
That dog isn't there, but you know there's at least 3 others.
Okay.
Based on the howls and the spacing and...
Well, he holds up his flashlight and he knows the importance of getting that first aid kit, so he leads the way and he pushes himself out there with the flashlight blazing. And he doesn't go too far, just enough so that the next person can get out of the bus.
Okay.
So you're holding, essentially?
Well, he's using a move action.
We'll call you a third of the way to there.
Okay.
Because you went cautiously. You were you're halfway because you went a little more recklessly.
Yeah.
Next up is Joe Diffie.
Joe, obviously witnessing some of the commotion, springs forth from the bus.
Burly protector.
And, as he's heading up towards Wan Lo, grabs Edison and drags him with him.
Okay, I need a strength check for that.
Okay.
Really?
That's not too hard because he's like 90 pounds of Edison.
I know, right?
It's more about how much Edison slows him down.
I'm 104 pounds now. Thank you very much. I have the freshman 15.
Explodes on one of his strength rolls. He rolls an 11.
An 11. So it's more like he doesn't have to drag Edison so much. He just gets Edison to go a little quicker.
Yeah, Edison's not willing to kind of stand there by himself as he sees Joe go by and Joe grabs his arm and Edison willingly runs behind him.
Yes. All right. Are you heading toward the supply tent or are you heading toward the first aid tent? The camp, the professor tent.
Are they next? Aren't all the tents in the same area?
Yes, they are near each other. I just need to know generally which one you're heading toward.
I was heading towards the supply tent, but...
That's fine. I just need to know generally where you're going to be.
Yeah, machetes are more important than Band-Aids right now.
All right. Next up, after that...
Well, more importantly, it was getting to Wan Lo to make sure he's okay.
Okay, so Wan Lo is bleeding.
He's not wounded. He's superficially bleeding.
He's stunned, right?
He's shaken.
Would we call that a flesh wound?
I would say that if I had hit with a raise, it would have been worse.
Okay, yeah, okay.
No, there's ramifications if I hit with a raise.
Oh, if you wound?
Yes. No, if I hit with a raise.
Oh, hit with a raise, not even just a
pain. Yes.
Oh. Okay.
That's pretty good. That's not good.
So. All right, so next up is Ford, right? Spade before diamond?
He is.
Yeah. Or he's got clubs, but either way, sees.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. I know it's reversed up. It's
so diamond, sorry. Johnny Moon.
So Johnny Moon.
Johnny Moon rushes over to Wang Lo
and
picks him up and carries him, trying to protect him.
All right, you're
going to push him towards the middle of the
area. I'm going to need a strength check for picking him up and carrying him.
Help me.
One low is
right.
Four.
All right, you pick him up. You start running on. Two more of the dog things jump you. Dog things.
You didn't see that coming. You have unarmed defender?
No, I don't
have that. Ooh, both bang into you. Give me an agility check to see if you fall. Minus two, because they both hit you.
Oh, he's exploding.
Football player extraordinaire takes the hit and keeps on going.
I saw it coming. I lowered my shoulder. Bam.
Just like coach taught you.
Hey, 16 minus 2, 14.
And just to confirm, as a football player, don't you get a plus 2 on athletic checks? I think it's not part of your build. I saw that in the...
You still take 5 damage, which probably doesn't do anything to you. Does that... What's your...
No, your
toughness is 5.
So that would be you are shaken.
You are shaken. You don't...
So you didn't go down, but they rung your bells pretty good.
Yeah. They dinged you. All right, so 2 of you are shaken. Ford, you are up next.
I am up next.
I take pictures.
You have a flash on the camera.
Absolutely.
Second,
I have a flashlight. I have a flashlight on.
It's not in there.
And I back my way up so my back's against the bus, and I look to see if I can see any gas cans.
There's no gas can. You do notice that the hood has been opened and it looks like there's damage to the engine.
Great. The witch. All right, I hold.
You hold? Well, you're the end of the round.
Oh. Well, I hold. Doesn't that take plus 2 to the next round?
Adam's right. If you hold now, you go first next round, unless somebody gets a joker.
Yeah, I think so.
That's right.
But Bob's got to reshuffle them.
No problem.
Perfect. Then I'll hold.
I should do that sooner.
I am going to drop a house on this witch.
That was awesome, Mikey.
That's one of my favorite insults that I've ever heard is somebody was being a real bitch, and a third party said to somebody, you know, oh, don't worry. She's been upset ever since somebody dropped a house on her sister.
Oh, that's good too.
Love that one.
Nice.
Now I just have to wait for somebody to be mean to me.
I know, right?
People are mean to Bob.
All right, here we go. Next draw.
Adam, 5 of hearts. Bob, queen of hearts. Jeff, joker.
I gotta reshuffle again.
Add 1 to all strength rolls, minus 1 to academics.
Wow. So we have Johnny Moon with a joker. Followed up by Chris or Bob.
That is hearts versus clubs, reverse alphabetical.
So followed by Edison, followed by Ford. Ford is first, except for Jeff, because he hold.
Oh yeah, you're right.
So Jeff can act at any time. Otherwise, Ford is going first. After Edison comes creature 1, which you've established now as the witch. Followed up by Wanlo, by Doe Diffie, and lastly, the dog-like creatures.
Yep.
So you're shaking.
Hey, Bob, I'm just saying, FYI, you want to kind of give the guy with the gun the slightly higher cards from now on.
I'm throwing out jokers to our team every turn, so I just got to get it to you next time.
All right, so I'm still got...
You're still dragging, you're carrying Wanlo. You can make one of the tents at this point.
There's 2 dogs laying at our feet, too. And you have a plus 2 to everything. And you're shaking. You don't want to try and roll that off.
Yeah, see, first you want to roll off the shaking, or spend the Benny.
Try to roll first.
Yeah, roll first.
If that doesn't work, then spend the Benny.
Okay, basically, you need
that to... That is big. Spirit or bigger?
Spirit. Isn't it great you upped your spirit for this game?
Josh, do you have a
plus
2
on another deck of cards? Do you have the 2?
You know, I don't know what happens to the deck of cards.
6?
So you're no longer shaking, and you get your full turn.
All right. I'm going to rush into the tent. Which tent? I think the supply one.
My tent.
I am going to use my scavenger edge.
Oh!
That I get to use once per session to find something very useful.
You run into the supply tent.
That's my tent.
You said the supply tent.
Yeah.
Okay, you run into the supply tent. In your quick glimpse, you see 2 lanterns, 2 shovels, a pick, and a machete.
I grab a machete and a pick.
Okay.
Dual wielder.
The pick is heavy.
One of them.
The pick is heavy. You know that. You and I know you can't really wield a pick as a weapon.
I don't need a weapon, actually. I'm pretty okay with my hands.
You can, but you're going to be slow as crap swinging that thing around.
But if something falls to my feet, I can take it out with a pick.
Yes.
Are those 2...
There's also... I mean, there's other things in there. That's what you immediately notice.
Yeah. That's what I grab.
Yeah. You grab the machete?
I have my machete in my left hand. I'm left-handed.
Okay.
So you do a quick attack with that. that if I see something on the ground, I can drop the machete and use the pick to take something up.
You know, in theory, right. If you came out, I don't know how far away and you can come back in time, but two attacks is each attack at minus two, and then your move to go and pick up, is that an action move? So
yeah, I mean, he's already using up actions here.
So in theory, it'd be like minus four for each attack, but in theory, you can do a dual attack.
Is there any
minus six?
Is one of the lanterns on?
You're right, it's minus six.
No. You don't. Well, do one of you have a light?
Edison does.
All right, so that you glimpse those things, whether it's through moonlight or the flash
That's
of somebody
why
else's
I always
light.
Saw those things.
Right. All right.
All that time outside is going to be keen eye in the dark.
All right. Ford.
So good
with my flashlight, I'm going to make my way over to the fire. I'm going to look around to see if there's any sticks or brush.
Are you looking for a torch, you mean?
Not this round.
Correct.
Yeah, there's a stick poking out there. You can grab it and have a torch.
Nice.
It's lit. Have you ever done this? Have you ever pulled a stick out of the fire? How long does it stay lit?
About 2 seconds.
But it's still hot.
It stays hot.
It stays hot.
And I like watching the smoke come off it, but when the flame goes out and it's just embers...
All right, so you pull out your hot flaming torch.
Excellent.
Swirling it around.
Is there a tent around that nobody's in?
He's gonna put the tent
up. There were five tents. One was a supply. One was a screened tent with food. One was the tent the instructor was sleeping in. So there's two more tents. You don't know what's in them.
Oh man.
We're down the tent with the food in it. We don't need that.
I toss it to one of the other tents, perhaps. Or maybe I don't. And I stand there. I have the back to the fire, the ember in one hand, and my flashlight in the other.
You have a flaming weapon. Just a thought.
So basically, you're trying to ward off that side of the campfire from any creatures attacking that side? You're basically playing defense?
But there are two dogs that are on the ground in front of... Juan Lowe as well as target.
Well, Juan Lowe and
Johnny Moon took off.
Have already moved on.
Oh, okay.
All right. Oh, did I get dragged into the supply tent?
Yeah.
So you're alone in a you're in a dark tent alone with Johnny Moon.
Good. Let's get the
fuck
out of here.
Are you happy to see me?
Is that a pickaxe in your pocket, or are you just happy to see me?
After stop meeting like this, Johnny Moon. People will talk.
So you've been dragged in there. That was why I limited his turn a little bit.
Oh,
more.
Okay, I didn't realize I got dragged in there.
All right, so Ford picks up the flaming torch. He's for the lack of a better term, defending that side of the tents. You can see catch glimpses of the creatures out in the dark, afraid to approach the fire. You can see they're kind of dog like, but with more of a spiky back, like nothing you've ever seen.
And has Edison ever seen anything like this on all of the countless hours of YouTube that he's watched?
He has never seen porn like this.
Wow. Okay.
Wow. I'm surprised, because rule 39? Ah, oh, never mind.
You don't know how to have what?
All right, Jeff is gone. Chris is gone. Edison's turn.
Edison has the only things he needs. He's armed with a smartphone and his wits.
Oh, boy, he's dead.
He wonders briefly if there's an app that he can play that will help him. But then he doesn't. He wishes that he had Tinder right now. But he doesn't think that would help him either. But then he wonders, what exactly is Tinder? But then he realizes, get with it, man. Get yourself together. You've got to help out here.
His turn's over, okay?
he races towards the supply shed to help his friends.
Okay.
Are there dogs near? Well, it doesn't matter. It's not
so nobody's going for the first aid kit yet.
Oh, he goes for the first aid kit. Yeah.
That's in the other tent.
Yeah, fine. He goes into the other tent for the first
aid. Alright, you get into the tent.
What does he see?
But we'll find out next turn.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Alright, next up is the witch. So...
Who's still outside? Is it just Ford?
And Joe Diffie.
Forgot about Joe Diffie.
Yes. And the dogs.
But now it is his turn. It's Joe Diffie, isn't it?
No, it's the witch.
Oh, the witch.
Oh, the witch got the queen. Or Jack,
the Baba
Yaga. Yeah. Yes. The Bruja. Bruja? Bruja?
Bruja.
Bruja. And
Bobby Dog is more European.
Not to be confused with Baba Ganoush.
No,
Baba Ganoush, that's a good stack, isn't it?
Yeah, one is edible and one is evil.
All right. Edison, Edison jumps into the tent and think voodoo doll, stabbing you with 20 pins all at once. You're in whatever the witch has done has caused you extreme pain.
Okay.
So you need to make a spirit roll before any other action.
He screams in agony.
You guys don't know what's going on, but Edison is screaming his head off like somebody has cut his leg off.
Now, I will remind you, he does have a necklace given to him by the shopkeeper's wife. I'm not sure if that helps. But
no. Just okay. You can hope it does.
Do that spirit roll now or next turn?
No, when your turn comes up.
Okay,
all right. Otherwise, you're going to be in trouble. Okay. So you are receiving pain transference. And I should look up what that does, really, but it's much more fun to describe it this way. So I'm sticking with it.
Okay.
I'm going with it.
I feel like when I got flamed on that message board when we were talking about which was better, Babylon 5 or Deep Space 9.
Wanlo, you're in the tent with Johnny Moon. You have a huge chunk of flesh missing from your arm where the
but
bite mark was.
It doesn't hurt. I'm just a little stunned. Shaken, one might say.
One might say that you are shaken.
Well, why don't you get rid of that shaking?
Shake it up, baby.
Spirit now, that shows off the air now.
What's your spirit?
My spirit is D8.
Okay.
I'm very faithful.
You only have to beat a 4, right?
Yeah. And I do not.
If you want to... well, now you can raise a penny and raise it all together if you want.
Let me see something real quick. Oh, post spirit, post for 3. Yeah, I don't have to roll. I'll just get rid of it.
All right. Digs deep. Shakes it off.
What else is there in the supply tent?
I guess you still get your turn at that point.
Yeah,
you don't lose it when you drop it.
You don't have any. You don't. You have to do a real notice check then to see what else is in there. You don't have light.
Okay, so I will do a notice check.
-2.
You brought light?
Notice check at -2.
Can I bust out my cell phone? Do you have time to do that?
You can try opening the tent flap too to see if the fire lets in.
Bust out my cell phone. 3.
So you whip out the cell phone.
-2?
You know how when your fingers get really cold, they don't work?
Yes. Clammy with fear, for example?
Perhaps.
Your password was incorrect. You have 5 more tries.
All right, Adam was next. All right, guy with the gun.
Awesome, guy with the gun.
If you want to give me a notice check, I will tell you if you see anything you can shoot at.
Perfect, that's what I was actually going to ask, because I was going to say, what do I see? So, my notice is a 5.
All right, you see at least 3 of the dogs approaching the tents. One you feel you have a good shot at without any, you can see it kind of silhouetted by the fire. You feel you have a good shot at it.
Okay.
You do not realize, though, that if you have a critical failure, there's a good chance you'll hit somebody in a tent.
Yeah, that's right. They're next to the first aid kit, so.
It's D&D all over again.
Except that it's not Jeff.
It's not you getting hit. Yeah. Oh, well, it could be you.
But no, because Mike's not gonna critical. He's not going to roll snake eyes.
All right, so Joe raises the pistol, gets a good solid aim. And he's gonna fire at that dog, at the dog that's silhouetted by the fire. And he rolls a 7.
All right, so that's a successful hit. Just need damage. That is a.
What the hell is that?
Yeah, that is shooting again. That's what I want. What is that gun? I don't know what gun it is, so I don't.
Yeah, I gotta look that up. Give me a second.
It's probably 2d6.
My guess would be 2d6 because that seems to be a very common shooting.
We did 5 sessions of Deadlands, but we still don't remember how much damage we had.
It was like a year ago.
And then we did like a year of War of the Dead with Glocks, and we still don't remember.
I remember that the Glocks were 2d6.
Yeah.
All right, Revolver. So a Colt Dragoon, which is probably not appropriate.
No.
Derringer?
No.
No.
Colt
1911?
No.
No. It's close-ish.
A 1911 is a semi-automatic.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, these people don't really know guns, Mike.
Okay. I mean, I'm running down the options here. You know, it's a basic six shot revolver. 2d6.
It's probably a 45 or a 40 at least.
It's either a 38 or a 357.
All right, the SMW Smith & Wesson 357 is not the Dirty Harry. Is 2d6 plus 1.
2d6 plus 1, you got it.
Actually, I think it is a Dirty Harry.
The cannon goes off.
Ooh, explodes on 1. So that's 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 points of damage.
Mikey drops, Joe Diffie.
Holy moly.
Squeezes the trigger, hits this thing square in the face. It just, the face just evaporates. Startling even Joe Diffie, who's probably never actually killed a wild animal.
Nice shot there, Mike. That was very
impressive. No, I've only shot in a range.
Yeah, so you're noticeably, adrenaline is way off the charts now. You know.
What about doing any future shots?
You now have 4 bullets left.
Actually, since Joe Diffie has the hindrance of overconfident, he's strutting his shit right now.
See,
he's like, bring it on, you little beasties.
And in about 30 minutes, this story is going to be, I shot 3 with 1 bullet. Mike's like, well, yeah.
I was going to say, isn't that kind of obvious?
I was going to say, 30 minutes? What do you mean? That's what just happened right now.
All right, dogs. There are 2 dogs around the tent that you are aware of. They both jump on. Actually, no, they don't both. Okay, they both jump on. They both jump on Edison's tent with him in it. Oh. So there's 2 dogs jumping on the outside of the tent that you are trapped in now with 2 dogs on top of it.
Okay.
Tearing at it, trying to get in there. They are going to get an attack roll at -2.
Don't worry, the nylon will protect me. Oh, wait.
It's canvas up here. It's canvas.
Canvas.
Which is probably better for you than nylon.
Except for the one that tears through with a 10 on its fighting roll.
I did up my vigor, but that doesn't help me since my agility is d4 and my parry is also d4.
Well, your vigor will, if you bump up your vigor, it also bumps up your toughness, I believe.
Yeah, which I'll need. Yeah. Hopefully
not.
3 damage.
Oh, toughness of 5. Woohoo!
So then somehow his glass jaw holds together.
Edison is shrieking and writhing in pain, and it just so happens that when the witch stabs the voodoo doll, he jerks to the left, and the dog bites to the right, and it's a weird, uncoordinated.
It tears through your pant leg, but not making the skin.
Bad dog, bad dog. I say, sit, boy, sit.
Actually, I believe what you're saying is.
That's true.
And the next one comes out of the darkness and attacks Joe Diffie because it does have some intelligence. Knows that there's a threat right there. So, Mr. Diffie, it misses. It attacks at you. You dodge to the one side. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. You dodge to the side and it just barely, you barely get away with not getting hurt.
Okay.
All right, so status check. Chris is outside on the fire. He has one side of the base basically under control with his torch. Coach Heese is in the supply tent. He has a machete in his left hand and a pick in his other.
It's pretty badass.
Wallow is in there. He's trying
fumbling
to get his,
for his phone.
Fumbling for his phone to find out what's there. He is no longer shaken.
He needs to check Facebook right now. It's so important.
Edison is trapped inside a tent with 2 creatures on top of it.
An excruciating pain.
And Joe Diffie is by the tent, squeezing him off. By the bus.
Whoa, wait a minute.
By the bus.
The gun, right?
Yes. You want to shuffle him up or deal him out there, Bob?
Uh-huh. I already shuffled.
I hope this is an exciting combat.
Every day you're shuffling?
I hope this is an exciting combat. I think it's pretty good.
Okay, here we go again.
Those cards don't think have ever been dealt.
Round 3. Oh, Adam. Oh, look at that.
Oh.
Is that
very awful?
Oh. Okay. All right,
so we have Edison going first with an ace. Wong Lo going next with a king. The dogs with an 8. The witch with a 1. And then Ford. The witch with a 6.
Oh.
Ford, followed by Cochise, and lastly, the guy with the gun.
you got a 2, Mike. I'm sorry, I tried to give you the Joker. My apologies.
You got the ace and the 2 mixed up.
I ended up with the ace, and you ended up with the 2. The guy with the cell phone, he's in pain. Yeah.
All right, so Edison, I need a spirit roll from you.
Sure.
To see if you break the whatever hold the creature has on you with the pain.
Edison is in excruciating pain. He got a 5.
All right, so you're able to function. If you failed, every roll will be a -2 going forward for this turn.
Okay.
Okay. So you are in the tent trying to find the first aid kit.
Yes.
In the tent that is collapsed with two dogs on top.
Right, so notice check to find the first aid kit.
Yeah, I'm going to give you notice check at -2.
He's a lover, not a fighter. Okay.
Notice his D6. Edison is not in a good spot.
He got a 5 on his notice check.
-2?
Oh, he's got a 3 on his notice check. Oh, wait, but I'll bend you.
I don't want to say that for Socrawls.
Well, I got 2 more. Explosion, double explosion. So
they don't bite very hard. No.
6+5. 11 on his notice check. -2 is a 9.
All right, so Edison finds the...
Laser of Focus Edison. The adrenaline actually helps him.
Yes.
He grabs hold of the first aid kit.
Okay.
And while he's struggling, he finds a 24-inch maglite.
Well, big heavy motherfuckers.
Big metal club with a flashlight at the end.
Oh. Do you know what this means? I could save the battery life of my phone now, so I can play Angry Birds later. This is fantastic. Oh yeah, also I guess I could use it as a weapon.
Yeah, alright. Well, seeing as there's a dog right there, and he's in mortal danger, he lifts up the maglite, his puny muscles straining just to hold it.
I don't know that you can hit from within inside the tent. You can try to scurry out.
How did they attack him if they're not...
They're just chomping at the tent, and they jumped on it and started chomping.
Okay. So he's going to get out of the tent.
So why don't we give an agility to see if you figure out how to get out of the tent, and then we'll call that your turn.
Okay, he's got a...
It's probably just second action, but we'll let it slide.
I don't think there's any...
Considering I got boned out of my action last turn, I'm okay with this.
Oh.
4.
Still a little better.
You rolled the dice, not me. What, 4?
Yeah.
Somehow Edison slides out of the tent. His feet are, you know, he's trying to get out. His feet and lower half are out.
I think that's it.
That's enough for Edison. Next up is Juan Lu.
Do I have to roll again and turn my phone on?
No, you got your phone on.
All right, what do I see?
As I stated to Jeff, there's several shovels. There's another machete. There is...
C4 explosive.
There's some brushes and brooms, you know, dustpans.
Oh, yeah.
All kinds of
sifting.
Sifting stuff. There's all kinds of little storage compartments and containers to hold stuff.
How big are the sifting grates?
12-inch circle.
Shield?
Is
that
what
it's like? It's small, though.
I'm trying to think what else would be in there. If you have a suggestion. A couple hammers, pitons. Oh, you got a hammer and spike, so you can piton the door open later on.
Is there a garbage?
Never ever used for climbing.
A garbage bin with a lid, that would be a good shield for you.
Garbage. There's garbage bags. There's some foodstuffs.
Is there one of those portable grills with the lid?
Oh, the levers?
No, but there's a grill, metal grate that you would put over your campfire to grill with.
How big is that?
That's a little bigger. That's probably about 18 by 2 feet, 3 feet.
Oh, I assume there's also a propane?
No propane.
Propane and propane accessories?
No, you have fire.
Okay. Lighter fluid?
I'll give you a lighter fluid container. 1.
Trying to help you out here. I got
nothing. Yeah, no, I just had like, yeah. Okay, so after finding nothing of value in the tent... Can Wanlo still race outside and see what he can...
Yeah, I mean, you can grab a shovel and at least use it as a club.
He doesn't need it. He's a martial artist.
That's true. I'm sorry there's no brass knuckles and nunchucks in there.
Yeah. Yeah, so Wanlo will go outside and they said that the spy tent was next to the...
Yes.
So he can maybe try and scare off one of the dogs.
Sure, you can lay a punch into him.
I'm going to try to kick this one, you know. Just hoping it's got a side turn to me and I got a good shot.
You're going right for those ribs again, aren't you?
Yep. So that's my five. I'm going to do fight. I'm going to do something sexy. Plus one. Ah! Five.
It has a parry of six. So you kick at it. It glances off to the side as it's trying to attack Edison and taking notice of you. You get a pretty good look at it at this point because you're pretty close to the fire. I'll just show you the picture.
Oh, you got a picture of
nice.
The
guy. Come on, dude. When do I fail?
I know.
What was that?
You made us work to get to see this. It wasn't just, it looks like this. No, we've been fighting this thing for 20 minutes now, more than that.
By the way, Chris.
Yes?
I am reminded, I know you're watching Supernatural. There is an episode coming up in a couple of years where they go to a live-action role-play for a weekend. You're going to love it.
Okay, say, big time.
Is Chris a big LARPer? Does he poker and LARP?
He'll have to tell you his experience at Medieval Fair a
couple of years ago. So, all right, so that is... what you see.
Whoa.
I say I actually ran towards that thing?
That is a malevolent beast.
Wanlo temporarily has a guts of plus two and an intelligence of minus two.
I mean, it's got spikes on its back leading all the way to its head. Its face is curled in sort of this atavistic sinister snarl.
It's got flaps on its toes and wings on its nose.
Man, that's ugly.
Oh. It's got a tail.
You know what it looks a little bit like? Like the evil dogs from Ghostbusters. But, like, sharper. Like, you can poke an eye. Yeah.
Taller and leaner.
Yep.
Big spikes in the back.
Yeah. So, apparently, this is the Mexican Ridgeback.
Everybody give me a notice check. Notice? Yeah, I'll take a notice check. Jeff?
Four.
These dice stink.
I'll take Chris did not do well. Mikey?
13.
So, Joe Diffie, because he's not up close, has a second to see it, and Edison are both very reminded of the image they saw in the fire from Johnny Moon's grandmother. Not the same creature. One more two-legged and upright, and one more four-legged, but there is almost... You want to say there's a link there?
Gotcha.
All right, back to combat. That was one low end... All right, so the dogs go.
Sort of how this dogs in The Simpsons look a lot like the people in The Simpsons.
Yeah. With big round eyes. And
so the...
three fingers.
The dog next to Mikey attacks him. Dog next to Joe Diffie. That is a four. What's your parry?
Five.
All right, so the dog is unable to... You once again are able to defend it off. The one that Wanlo tried to kick, one. Edison's mad scurrying gets under its paw and it slips out and does not respond. Isn't capable of
furthering out. It tries to leap and then the bottom goes out of one of its paws.
Yes, and the last one takes one more chomp at Wanlo. You guys are lucky. My dice suck tonight.
Uh-huh.
That one's a six.
That's a hit.
So it's a. Claw bite kind of thing.
Thank goodness it only didn't hit a raise.
It's strength plus D4. It's strength plus 4. So it's a D4 plus 4. Uh-huh. So I have to roll pretty good for you.
That could be bad. I've only got a...
7.
That's a shaken.
That's a shaken on Edison.
Yeah. How many
is? On one bow?
I'm sorry. I was on Edison trying to get out of 10.
Oh.
My bad. The first one missed you. The first one slipped out on the 1.
So toughness is 5. My parry's a 4, so you definitely hit. You didn't get a raise on that hit, did you?
No.
It was a
7. Seven.
Okay. So I am shaking. Edison is shaking.
No wound, though.
No wound. He's all right. Toughness of 5.
All right, so next up is the Bruja. And she cackles some more. And you can. It almost sounds like she's pulling off away.
Her voice is getting
more. And your dog, too.
But you know, if she was really smart, what she would do is she'd stay right there at the outskirts of the fire, and then she'd go, ha ha ha, loud, and then make it soft.
All right.
And then she'd do fake footsteps.
She's smart.
And then she'd come back at us. Next round.
Ford, you're up.
I am up. All right, what am I looking at?
All right, so you are still by the fire. Johnny Moon has come out. He's kind of by your side, I'm guessing. Juan Lo came out. He is decked, or tried to deck one. Edison is trying to come out, but he is shaken. Joe Diffie is by the bus, plunking out bullets. He's down to three left.
Yeah.
Because he shot two.
All right, what's the closest?
Did you shoot one or two, Mikey?
What's that?
This is our second or third round, so he shot at least twice.
But it took him a round
to get it. Shot two, two of them are down. I have three bullets left.
Right.
That's great.
So, I mean, the four of you are almost in this place where you can do a kind of a phalanx-controlled retreat together.
Guys, let's do a phalanx-controlled retreat together.
You're shaking. You can't say that. You're shaking. You can't say anything.
Oh,
you can
still talk when you're shaking.
You can.
All right. I notify everybody. Let's head to the bus. Let's join and head to the bus. Safety in numbers.
I mean, you are you the last one to go? No. Johnny still has to go. I mean, you guys can try to drag Edison if you want to make the progress quicker.
Hey, Johnny Moon, why don't we grab Edison and drag him back to the bus?
We have the first aid kit.
Edison has the first aid kit. He has the maglite. You have the pick and the machete.
I have
a flashlight.
I grab him, I guess.
You gotta drop one of the weapons.
Pick or the machete?
I drop the pick.
Okay.
You can give it to somebody.
It's not your turn. It's Chris's turn.
Oh, sorry.
I mean, Chris, if you and Chris decide to have your turns work together simultaneously, I have no objection to that.
Yes.
It's not my turn yet, so I can't say.
All right, Johnny Moon. Let's grab what we can. More importantly, Edison, and let's get back to the bus.
So, what does he have in his hands?
He has a torch that's not really a torch. He has a hot stick.
Okay.
Oh, it's hot, all right.
And a flashlight.
I throw the pick in the direction of the bus.
And okay. You hit
the tire.
John Diffie.
And then I grab
Edison
under the arm and start dragging him in.
Alright, so you two each give me a strength check. Ford and Johnny Moon, give me a strength check. Johnny Moon's burned as many as tonight.
Mm-hmm.
I'm lucky I'm supposed to have a plus one, Benny. Five.
All right, Ford, what's your strength roll?
My double strength? I am, like, massive. Okay. It's going to be double ones because these suck. Oh, no, it's a four and a two.
All right. Four. So you guys are both successful in grabbing Edison. You get halfway back to the bus. So the group is halfway back except for Joe Diffie, who's still at the bus. Joy Hines, has finally gone hoarse from screaming. And we got to deal one more time there, Mr. Jones.
Yes, sir.
Nope, the other one.
Same deck. Right, we need a few jokers. I know we've seen so many jokers tonight.
I know.
All right, this is your round, Mike. I got a good feeling for Joe Diffie here. Here we go. Adam first.
Ooh.
Okay. Here comes Mike's.
Two.
Oh, my God. It's not quite the lowest card in the deck.
All right, so Edison is up first with a queen.
So if we're all in a controlled sort of circle traveling together, Edison doesn't want to surge ahead because he wants to be sure he does his job as part of the group. So
aren't you being dragged?
Oh, yeah.
Well, he's recovering. He's able to recover himself at this point.
I have to recover from shaking.
Oh, so you have to recover from shaking. That's right.
All right, so let's do that first. That's a spirit check, spirit D6. Explosion 9. So shaken is gone.
He is no longer shaken or stirred.
Okay. Can he run into the bus at this point? Is he close enough that he can make it into the bus?
You can break formation and sprint for the bus, or the group as a whole will make it there at the end of the turn.
They'll travel with the group.
Okay. So you're on. What's what I'm looking for? You're prepared to strike anything that comes close.
Yeah, that's fair.
On guard.
On guard. Thank you. Got it.
I don't think it's the actual term of the game.
No.
Readying an action so that when anybody comes within one square of him, he makes...
Yeah, that's really just a 4E term that I don't think Savage World supports, but we're going to support it because it makes sense.
So monster number two.
Monster number two is the dogs.
Yeah, well, that should be an interrupt, but yeah.
The dogs...
For all those listening, all those who peg ain't gonna listen.
The dogs continue to growl, but none of them approach. Mm. In fact, the one that was close to Joe Diffie withdraws a little bit into the darkness. Mike is going to have to roll the raise to see anything adequately enough to shoot it this time.
Edson pushes the button on the noise that makes the predator sound on his phone.
You mean the one that drew him here in the first place?
There's a lot of growling, but
no. No, you can't do that because I didn't have your phone. I wanted to take your phone, but you gave it to me.
Didn't want
to
load the tape?
I think you've been using it since then.
I must have given it back. Yeah.
There's no action from the witch that you could tell.
All right.
Your pain has subsided, by the way.
Oh, thank God.
That was worse than the worst migraine that I've ever had.
All right. Ford Prefect, you're up. Ford? Chris?
He's frozen.
You're
up.
Yep. Oh, good. Oh, all right. You break up so I don't hear you.
I'm sorry. All right,
so I'm going to make it back to the bus.
What? Video is frozen.
Yeah. All right, so you guys, at this point, there's no more creatures to go. I'm going to say you make it back to the bus.
Yeah.
You can still hear the creatures out in the dark, but none of them are attacking.
Okay.
Inside the bus, there's blood. There's a ton of blood from from his arm wound. You know.
How many rounds was that?
That was 4 rounds.
That was like 20 seconds?
You're using a D&D round.
Actually, I think it's defined as about 6 seconds. Yeah.
So.
I just like the bus boss.
I know.
Missy.
All right, so healing check. How's he doing?
You have the medkit.
Yes. If anyone can assist me, I've done a little bit of this and I took a community first aid class, but that's about it.
Missy can assist. All
right.
She was an EMT at high school. She finished the EMT class.
She's going to be a nurse.
That should be pretty bad. She's pretty nurse.
So Missy should roll her healing check.
She rolled a 4.
All right. So
you get a +2.
And +2 from the aid kit.
You don't get a minus. Well, yeah, you get +2 from the aid kit, yeah.
So it's
net
+2.
Yeah.
Okay. Rolled a 4 with the +2 from Missy, puts it at a 6.
All right, so you're able to bandage the wound enough. The tourniquet had helped some. You're able to, you know, stem the bleeding, clean it out. He's pasty white.
Guys, he's lost a lot of blood. All we've done is stop the bleeding, but we really need a professional here. We gotta get this man to the hospital.
Turn the fan on.
Yeah, you might want to open up a window over there too, Jeff, while you're up. Get some cross breeze.
Is he conscious? Is he alert?
Yeah, he's conscious and alert, but he's struggling.
Okay.
You know. It's still not late. I mean, it's only like 10:30, 11 o'clock.
That's late.
Does the bus move, guys? Can we get the bus and get him out of here? Get him some help?
Who got the keys?
I have the keys. So who noticed it earlier, though?
It was, Ford Prefect noticed that.
Ford.
Noticed what?
Ford, what'd you notice about the bus, Ford?
Engine, guys. I did notice that the engine hood was open, and it looked as if somebody had tampered with it.
Edison groans loudly.
Juan Lo starts praying. Oh my God, I'm perfectly sorry today for having offended thee, and I detest all my sins because of that just punishment. Go ask for the rest of it. I also only know the old version.
This is the worst archaeological trip I've ever been on.
Is it the only archaeological trip you've ever been on?
Yes, it's also the only archaeological trip I've
all
ever
I know
been
is
on.
That this belongs in a museum. I don't know what this is, but it belongs in a museum.
All right, so it's still... The night ain't over yet.
Well, does everybody have a weapon at this point? Thorin, have you got something you could hit the bad guys with?
I do have my pocket knife.
There's a couple of machetes still in the supply tent.
Somebody, we'll let somebody have picked up the pick that Jeff thrown halfway.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
You could have kicked that along. So you have Jeff has his machete, the pick. Edison has the mag light. Wanlow has his fists. Fists of Fury! Joe Diffie has 3 bullets left.
And if we were willing to brave another run to the supply tent, there are more machetes there. So you guys have fun with that.
Professor, do you have any more ammunition?
This isn't my gun. I found it in the tent.
Where's your gun?
I don't have a gun.
You're in Texas. You should have a gun.
Yeah, but I'm not from Texas.
Which tent?
He found the gun in the professor's tent. The one that's collapsed now, so searching it is going to take a little bit of time.
So the first aid tent. I don't think it's wise for us to leave this bus until morning. What do you guys think?
I think you might be right.
Do we stay here and hold them off? And then try to get out and see what's going on in the morning?
I will hold them off.
Does the bus start? Maybe they didn't break it. Maybe the hood is open, but we stopped them before they did anything. Maybe we should try to start the bus.
Where are we going to drive to?
Away from here.
How long did it take to get?
It took like 4 hours to get up there.
From and the mountain. Little general area.
Yeah, yeah. And you didn't pass anywhere else in civilization.
Were we even on a road?
Barely. And let's face it, like I described the drive up there, you couldn't drive in the dark on the way down.
There were times we were scraping up against the foot.
Oh, well, that's right. I forgot about that.
Well, how about this? Let's see if the bus works, because if the bad guys come back, we can just run them over. We have a 4-ton piece of equipment here that we could use as a weapon.
If we had a moment.
Right.
So go fix it.
Well, let's start it.
You go out there and go fix it.
Who's got the keys?
Dr. Chad has the keys. He offers them up.
Okay, we take the keys.
You take the key.
We try to start the vehicle.
You hear it start to click. You can see the shadow of the fluid. Like you have the fire in the distance. You see a fluid shoot out.
He stops immediately. Does Edison have any sense using a repair knowledge?
Now without looking at it.
Okay, now without looking. All right.
Obviously, a hose is either gone, cut, or broken.
Yep. Guys.
I think it's one of the hoses.
I think it's one of the hoses. I think the bus ain't moving.
So.
Damn it! Ships. We've been hosed.
Oh! But I missed the corny!
There it is.
Alright, so we're sleeping in shifts?
Yeah?
Alright. I'll take the first shift sleeping with Missy.
I think Dr. Chad should be on the second shift.
I don't think Dr. Chad is going to be able to do anything. Mm. So it's sleeping on Missy? She's not that kind of girl.
Part of shift is watching Doc.
Yeah, and I'm thinking whoever's on shift should have the gun. If you guys agree,
yep.
That makes sense.
Who actually knows how to handle the gun?
It doesn't matter.
I do.
Edison's got a D4.
Wouldn't be the first time Wamo's touched a gun.
I will take first shift.
I'll join you.
I'll take the daylight shift.
What a nice guy.
Yeah, you know.
Hey, Ford, did you get a picture of those things?
I got a picture of the tracks. I did. Unfortunately, I was scared for my life and didn't get a picture.
Oh. Well, next
there
time.
Are, I mean, there are, in theory, two dead ones out there somewhere.
Can we see them from the firelight?
No.
Here's another question. How long is that fire going to last before it goes down?
Well, Dr. Chad is just stoking it up before running to the bus, so I'll assume you threw a couple logs on it. It'll probably get you through most of the night.
Okay.
It'll get you a few hours.
Okay. So we try to pass the night. We take our shifts.
We're still on that same deck if we don't combat.
All right. First pair up is...
Me and Edison.
You and Edison, please give me a bigger roll to stay awake.
Oh, thank God I leveled up bigger. It's now just crappy. Oh, five.
Oh my God! Bless you.
Wow, bless you.
Four.
Bless you.
It is a true struggle for Johnny Moon to stay awake. He does. Edison, used to staying up all late night programming, doesn't have any problems staying up that late.
If you were all that adrenaline, you'd be fine.
Johnny, thank you.
Oh, adrenaline crashed.
Now that we're in a quiet place, I just want to thank you. I know you helped get me out of a bad spot there. Thank you very much. There was something weird, like I was in a tent, and then I felt like I had just been stung by 1,000 bees. Like I was in real pain, like somebody was doing something to me. Like, and I'm allergic to bees, and I would be dead right now if it was bees, because I'm very allergic. But
I've already said thank you.
Yeah, it was just...
How long is this? He's got an X watch.
Yeah, he's got an X.
Okay, so...
How long has it been? 3.5 minutes.
Do you guys take it on top of the bus? Do you?
I'm staying in the bus.
Yeah. I think we just stay watching. If they try to get in,
we have the door closed. We're sitting back from the window.
Windows open.
We reinforce the windows with like packs and we get the seats and stuff.
All right.
So by the time the bus is reinforced, the sun's coming up.
2 hours go by. Who's on the next watch? Wanlo and.
I'll take it.
That was Joe.
Yep.
All right, Wanlo.
I give Joe the gun.
Wanlo and Joe, give me a
Wanlo, assuming he stays awake.
Bigger check.
Spends the whole shift trying to keep Joe from smoking his wacky tobacco.
Joe needs a drink and some wacky tobacco after that.
I'm getting rid of this dice. It sucks.
Five. Still rolled a five.
Oh, another Benny. Ah. Wanlo needed a Benny to stay awake.
Joe Diffie, this is just like staying up late night for a party.
Nine.
Yeah.
And Wanlo, he just can't turn the adrenaline off. Did you see me hit that thing? Gone!
Reminds of my old days in Hong Kong.
All right, so your watch heads by. It's now about 3 in the morning. Last batch would be, I'm guessing Trout. Ford. Trout and Ford.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a reliable crew.
Yeah.
All right, let's get rid of these things here. All right. Spirit check?
We can't even shake out to get them up.
Bigger. Oh, good.
All right,
new dice.
Out,
don't fail now.
I don't know if you want that.
Woohoo!
Missy's like, fine, I'll take his turn.
I'm awake.
11.
All right. So Ford, used to his journalistic watching, spying people. He makes it through the weird hours of the night. Play with the kid over there?
Yeah.
And I'm also jotting down in my notebook everything that the people are saying and what I witnessed.
Finally, as it couldn't come soon enough, the sun starts to break the horizon, and the day begins. Fire's just a smoking mess now. Burned out somewhere around between the second and third. Somewhere you guys changed over there.
How's Dr. Chad doing?
Dr. Chad is weak, but he's okay.
Okay.
He has a level of fatigue.
We ply him with plenty of fluids, water, the traditional.
Yes. So it's now morning.
Now we go take a look at the vehicle. Under the hood, how bad is it?
Under the hood, it's bad. Hoses. Most of the hoses have been cut or removed. The battery terminal has been disconnected, but it like fell back on. That's how you got it to charge up.
Okay.
How you got, you know? But it's so it's still there.
Nice detail.
But it's not going to run.
Do we have any materials in the camp that can replace the hood?
You have to look.
We're all on duct
tape. We'll have to look for it. If only we had somebody who can scavenge.
Oh, it's a day, or is it a once per session?
Once per session.
Once per session.
Okay. I still have the ability, but it's only better for them.
Understood.
So it's what you're saying is that it's useless right now.
Like, I have the ability right now to pole vault 17 feet.
Yeah.
I have the ability. I just don't...
Have a stick.
Have a stick. We can't do it.
So you're ready, though.
All right, so the morning comes.
Oh, are the bodies still there? Do we see the bodies of the creatures?
The bodies seem to have been... they're almost down to just bone already.
Ooh.
I mean, they're decomposing extraordinarily quickly.
Hey, Ford, you might want to get your pictures now. It looks like they're not going to be here for much longer.
It just looks like a dog... It just looks like a dog now.
Son
a
it's
dog
okay.
carcass.
I'm still snapping some shots.
That's fine.
Can we carve up what's left from meat? Or
there's no meat left. There's no meat left.
I'm not eating that.
I thought maybe we pulverized it too bad. But
oh.
You're making a
just the faces.
The
there,
just the faces where you punched it.
Are there fire ants surrounding them?
No. They just broke down really quickly.
Well, that's really strange.
So,
let's help set up that other tent and see if we can find inside there. Somebody else should go with the supply tent.
Yep. So we collectively apply searching and try to find either additional supplies, additional weapons, defensive items, or things that we can use to repair the vehicle.
All right. So,
I'm looking for trap doors.
I'm poking every square with my tent.
That's later. So you reset up the professor tent. It's got holes and such in it. Inside you find a few sleeping bags, a couple packs with some clothing in it, toothbrushes, you know, the normal stuff. You find a box with Four more bullets in it, Mikey.
Four more bullets? Okay, cool.
So you're up to, I believe that leaves you seven bullets?
Seven bullets.
Bullocks. In the supply tent, which was not damaged, now that you can get a good look at it, there's a foodstuff section. Oh, that and between that and the screened-in tent where the food was, you find coffee, so on and so forth. You know, bread for toast, pancake mix. You can whip some of that up. A couple cast iron skillets.
Do we find any items that we could use to repair?
Well, I'm trying to get you through breakfast first.
Well, it seems to me that for Edison's point of view, repairing the vehicle takes precedence over breakfast.
Not from Wanlow's view.
No.
Wanlow's 19 years old. And virile.
Fair enough.
You find some odds and ends, but not enough to construct the hose.
Okay.
You know, you find some duct tape. Maybe you could patch a hose, but not generate a replacement. The other bus that was there, you don't find keys for. The bus that brought the original group up.
Oh, there's two buses?
I said there was another vehicle there that brought the original group up. Geez. It was closed up, though. You don't have a way to get into it.
Well, we take the hose from the first bus.
You can't get into it. And they're not compatible. They're not compatible.
We use the pick, and we open up the hood, and then we steal. There must be a hose-like substance in the hood of the...
There are hoses.
They're formed hoses.
Yeah, you can't.
Form-fitted hoses.
But that plus duct tape equals solution. You can fit it with duct tape.
It's like, it bends the wrong way.
Yeah, they don't. If you've ever replaced like a radiator hose, you're not going to make another radiator hose fit in there. Even Jeff's seen that one.
All right.
Yeah, you have to hit the right hose.
Right. If like I said, if it was ripped, you patch that. But
does anybody know how to hotwire a bus?
Would that be lockpicking?
We still got to find out what happened. What happened to Dr. Vandekamp?
Well, I think we should, but we could go and get police. Send someone back with police while
that's at least a day. We got to go up to the site and see what happened.
Well, I agree.
See if we can find them up there.
Why don't we send two people back to get help while we're
along
meeting?
With the injured professor?
Yeah. Thank you, Wanlow.
Yeah, absolutely. We got to send them back with the injured professor. And then the rest of us who are left will continue on this adventure.
Well, I'm curious.
So I'll drive the bus. You guys all going up the mountain?
All right. I'll settle for either a lockpick or you have a...
I've got mechanical engineering as well.
I've got lockpick.
Repair might be a better choice. But let's a lockpicker here.
Yeah.
Give it a chance to shine.
Alright, here we go.
Oh.
I got a 5.
Ooh.
Alright.
I told you, the red and the green wire.
So Ford goes in there, he pulls out a little set of lockpicking tools, gets the ignition started somehow. The van is run. The bus is running.
Wow, Ford, you're a man of many talents. That was really impressive.
Well, there's a lot you don't know about me.
Did you ever see Gone in 60 Seconds with Nicolas Cage?
It took him 35 minutes to do it.
I'm a Fast and Furious guy.
Oh, all right. So, I think you'd like that movie.
Tony and Joy offer to take Professor Dr. Chad back.
Okay.
Missy looks to Jeff. Looks to.
You go back, Missy.
You sure?
Yeah.
Because I can help people. I can put you back together again a little bit.
I know. Help Dr. Chad.
All right. Be careful. Right. She gives you a hug and a smoocher.
Also, when you come back with help, make sure people bring satellite radios. Very important because the reception is no good here. Satellite radios. Just say it one time.
Satellite radios.
There
one
go,
time.
That's right.
Yeah. No, Edison, I'm just going to mention that the little shop down in town where we came from, I don't think they had satellite radios for sale in there.
Well, they had SPF 50, so they might have a couple extra in the back.
I'm sure that's where they have them stashed.
Did you notice it when you were...
Haven't you seen Commando? You just didn't press the button and open the...
open to get the rocket launcher.
Exactly.
That's it.
The big guns.
or did you ever see somebody pointed out on Star Trek the original series, the captain's chair, his chair has like three buttons. Two of them are communications. And
one was for when Russell's
done. One of them is like fire photons. Like, he just presses it and it fires. And you just have to wonder, when he gets knocked around, does he ever accidentally press the fire photon button? It's like communications one, communications two, massive destruction. Just three buttons right there.
Well, what do you need as the captain?
That's true.
I'm going to call these guys.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, I meant to hail you guys. Sorry about that big gaping hole in your
chest. And God forbid Captain Kirk is colorblind, because they're like red and green. Like, it's like...
Work out tomorrow.
Apparently, colorblindness has been
eradicated.
Yes.
Maybe.
No pattern baldness, yeah. No.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, so... The,
thank goodness for eugenics.
The four of them...
That's how we got the perfection of the 21st century, through eugenics, right?
The four of them head off. Dr. Chad gives you... Before that happens, Dr. Chad gives you directions on how to get to the dig site. The path does look pretty obvious. It's about a 20-minute walk.
Okay.
He says, be careful. We'll be back as soon as we can with some reinforcements or some help.
So we tell him, we'll be right back. No, wait.
Hey, Wanlo, did you say that you found some ladder food in one of the tents?
Yeah, it's my tent. There's some ladder, ladder food.
Is anybody having making breakfast or anything?
No, yeah, we're on deck cleaning breakfast.
They left.
No, before they left. What do you think they were doing for 35 minutes while Ford was trying to jumpstart the other bus?
Standing around. Nobody told them what to do. They're NPCs. No, they're NPCs. Nobody told them what to do.
But they're weird. They sure automatically know to take care of the men.
Oh, they're washing your clothes.
That's, I go around and do a notice check. All right. I look for bodies.
That's why it's funny.
It is. I look for food.
Okay.
I look for ways to cook. Seven.
So, I mean, in the food tent, you do find cans of corned beef hash. You found some bread. You found some pancake mix, which is just mixed with water, basic stuff. Beef jerky.
Yes.
Even though you don't need it now.
Wanlo still needs it.
So you find a, you know, whatever non-perishable food you guys would think would be appropriate up there. Enough to get certainly several meals out of. The supply tent, pretty much as described already. If you think of something else that should be there, I'm fine with it. There were a couple lanterns in there you didn't notice. Two more flashlights, small ones.
We grab those down. We write the tent that was knocked down.
The professor tent.
Yeah.
Right, like I said, Mike, we found four more bullets stashed in the Dr. Vanderkamp's bag.
That's in addition to the four that was already?
No, that was the four. They only found the four.
Yeah.
Yes, you found those four.
Jeff was sleeping on the last one. First was up
there. And you find his journal.
Oh, well, let's read the journal.
Talks
about, yeah, this could be personal stuff in here.
Yeah, that's why we're reading the journal.
No, you're right. We really shouldn't invade on his privacy. What if he's, you know, got personal, deep, sensitive issues like what I write in my journal, like in my blog? I wouldn't want anybody to be seeing that. That would be, you know, very humiliating.
We don't subscribe to a blog.
Oh, you do?
It's on the internet.
Oh.
Everybody got the internet.
Oh.
My mother reads it in Hong Kong.
Your mother is reading my blog? Oh boy, I got it. I don't have a signal. Delete! Oh god, this is horrible.
So.
Is there any heart, like alcohol that you can use as explosives?
Joe Diffie drank his bottle.
Okay.
Joe, did you have two bottles or just the one?
I'm sorry?
Did you bring one or buy one or did you just have the one?
I just had the one.
Okay. Did anybody get to drink the worm?
No, the worm we saved for Edison. It's still in the bottle.
Ooh, there's one more sip of courage in there for you.
There's a little swig left for Edison just to get him through the day today.
Is that something he drinks now, or do you present that to him now, or is that like celebration if we survive?
No, he should have that now, actually.
Tequila worm for breakfast.
What exactly is this, Joe?
This will help you get through the day today, Edison.
It's protein. It's good for you.
Everybody's had a swig so far.
Is it like a multivitamin?
It's kind of like a shot of courage, like a multivitamin, yeah, something like that.
Cactus juice, right? I mean, it's what keeps things alive in the desert, right, Mikey?
That's it. It kills bacteria from the bite from that dog last night.
Oh, I don't want that. Joe Diffie, I can't help but notice there seems to be a creature at the bottom of that bottle there. It looks a little bit like a worm.
Is that's the protein that goes with it?
What? What you're saying? I have to drink that?
Oh, yeah, no, it's a, you just drink it right down. Don't even bother trying to chew it. Just swallow it right down. It's kind of like,
okay.
You know, like, it's what makes the antibiotic work better.
I've got the...
All right, if you say so. Okay, just, do I sip? Is this a sipping kind of thing?
No. This is just chug it right down. One big gulp. It's like NyQuil. You don't want to drink it slow.
Oh, it's like the daytime sleepy so you can kill bad dogs medicine.
Exactly. Yeah, that's exactly what it is. Chug it right down.
Here we go. Watch out, stomach.
Just one big gulp.
And you are recognizing, of course, that there's still no bathroom.
Over the lips and through the gums. Watch out, stomach. Here it comes. And Edison gives it a kick back, imagining it was chocolate milk.
It's not chocolate milk.
His mouth burns. It's liquid fire covering his lips, his tongue, his throat immediately closes, but just after the word gets down, and he begins coughing and turns a shade of crimson red, and he starts hammering the side of the wall with his hand, and you can hear him whispering, "It burns!
Alright, Johnny Moon, and you're searching around, you find where the remains were not quite fully desiccated, what looks like sharp quills.
Oh.
Just a couple. They're falling apart. They're you know, the sunlight is rotting them out too, but it's definitely something you recognize as a scary potential way to get hurt.
So we should stab them. We can keep it as a...
It'll probably be no good by the end of the day. But it was more to see and be aware of another potential threat. So, all right, you guys have... You had your breakfast?
Oh, and one last thing. Edison has the MacGyver edge. So he'd like to leverage that edge now to try to create some sort of cool Molotov-esque bomb contraption, or put some rags together with the lighter fluid, something, and maybe... set it up with a lighter so we can throw it and make a makeshift bomb. I don't know.
All right, give me a check here.
What would you say? Repair, maybe?
Yeah, I'll go call repair.
Okay. Repair is a D8.
Okay. It did get warm in here.
Seven.
So Edison finds a couple of canning jars that have been used.
Okay.
And... put some lighter fluid in there, puts a rag in there, and he thinks it's going to act as a Molotov cocktail. He's able to make two.
Johnny Moon, I know you've got the best arm, being the quarterback and all. I have something for you.
Well, I haven't played quarterback in almost half a year now.
Well,
I guess that's okay.
I haven't
seen it. Oh, yeah. I was quarterback in high school.
Now you're cornerback.
Yeah.
And Joe Diffie obviously has a lighter. There are matches and such in the store, in the storage area. There are there's kindling. There's
here you go, John. Just be careful. I've set these up. You only have about 5 seconds, maybe 4 seconds, for them.
I've seen these before.
What? You've seen these before?
Oh, it's more like it's more about you throwing it and breaking and spreading fire everywhere.
That is true. You just gotta hit it and it'll spread. Good luck.
All right. Is that your breakfast? You're going to head up to the dig site?
I don't know about you guys, but I'm dying of curiosity to see what's up there.
Yeah, I think so.
No, you'll be dying, all right.
Let's go.
I locked up all the tents.
Do you think there could be a coven of witches up there? Do you think there could be, like, a whole, like, pack of dogs up there just waiting for us, chomping on our bones when we get up there? Oh, my gosh. What if we found a chupacabra? Wouldn't that be amazing? It would just, like, render us turned to stone when it looked at us.
Yeah. You see me?
That's a Medusa.
Oh, that's Medusa. You're right. Yeah.
All
right,
so you follow up the trail.
They could fly.
Round the bend. It's a 20-minute hike. It's uphill. Edison's winded. You're around the bend. You see that ruin.
Oh, that's architecture.
You don't see anybody.
No, we spend the night up here.
Should I shout out?
Let's take a quick go around it. See how big of a structure we're looking at.
I think that might be just about to stop.
What's that?
I think this might be a good spot to stop.
For the night. Yeah, okay. Fair enough. That was good. That was enjoyable.
All right.
All right. Is it a well?
Oh, wait. As we're walking up to it, I'm like, we are at Chicken Itchy.
Chicken Itchy.
This was one of the things where I read the one page, and I'm like, I don't think that's going to be enough. So I put all this stuff in it. It probably would have been enough. But now we have a whole, I probably have most of the next session already prepped too.
That's, cool.
That's good for me.
Oh, by the way, before we go, Chris gave me a call last week, and he shared with me that he had been to a medieval Renaissance fair. Is that right, Chris?
Yeah, it was actually called Robin Hood Spring Festival or something like that.
I was going to go to that, but my wife's like, that sounds like a rent fair. I'm like,
we're having a confessional here, or is that what that is?
And I was just curious, Chris, what your impression of the fair was.
It was unbelievable. They had dagger, spear throwing, axe throwing.